After weeks of posturing and refusal by Greece to accept fiscal terms necessary to bail it out of deep fiscal trouble, Greek voters on Sunday effectively told creditors the same thing. Thanks, but no thanks. As Greece continues to struggle to try to stay afloat amid its serious debt crisis, billions of dollars in financial relief offered by international creditors were rejected by a highly anticipated voter referendum on Sunday. Sunday's referendum on the bailout terms skewed heavily in the no column, exactly as Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras hoped, with the vast majority of the votes siding with the leader's Syriza party. Needing to pay a $1.7 billion payment to the International Monetary Fund by the end of June, but not having the cash to do so, Athens engaged in numerous negotiations over the last 4 months, hoping to strike a deal to unlock the remainder of $7 billion in relief cash previously granted by the organization. However, demands by creditors for Athens to cut government spending in exchange for the relief proved to be the deal breaker. Tsipras reportedly rejected the offer, saying the cuts would affect Greek workers' wages and state-funded pensions. Last week, Greece defaulted on the loans, and Tsipras, not wanting to uniformly reject help without public support, ordered Sunday's referendum. By late Sunday, 60% had voted against the IMF's bailout terms. German Chancellor Angela Merkel and French President François Hollande spoke by telephone Sunday night and agreed the Greek voters' decision must be respected. A spokesman for the German government said the chancellor and the president are in favor of calling for a summit of Eurozone heads of state and government heads on Tuesday.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports a Maine man died during a 4th of July celebration on Saturday night when he tried to launch a firework from the top of his head and it exploded, killing him instantly, according to police. Devin Staples of Calais, Maine, was drinking and celebrating the holiday in a friend's backyard when he placed the firework mortar tube on his head around 10 p.m., according to Stephen McLaughlin, a spokesman for the State Department of Public Safety. McLaughlin said it was unclear whether the firework was already lit or whether Staples lit it once it was on his head. He was killed instantly when it exploded. The tube Staples was using was a reusable mortar shell, according to McLaughlin, but said investigators did not know what type of firework he was attempting to shoot. Maine has allowed the sale of fireworks since lawmakers repealed a 60-year-old ban on them in 2011. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The Onion looks back at this week in history. On May 6, 1937, the explosion of the German passenger ship Hindenburg brought cheer to an entire generation of Americans in the midst of the Great Depression. The souls of the American people were fleetingly revitalized by the flame-engulfed Zeppelin and the shrill screams of burning passengers leaping to their heartwarming deaths.
Oh my, it's burst into flames! The burning embers and charred flesh are cascading splendidly onto the mooring mast. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the most terrific thing I've ever seen! Oh, the luminosity, the gaiety!
And on May 7th, 2000, Vladimir Putin became president of Russia after promising citizens he could bend anything they gave him with just his bare hands. And that was what happened this week in history. In the words of the Italian philosopher Niccolo Machiavelli, whoever wants to foresee the future must first look at the past and then imagine all that old stuff looking more futury and space-like.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can dial in, join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you here in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And you can join us online anytime you want over at freetalklive.com. So please enjoy the features you will find there. You actually get to create the content that you see on the site. other listeners have submitted, like news articles or YouTube videos or other things that they might think that you would be interested in, and you get to vote whether you like or dislike those things. So go and get interactive over at freetalklive.com. There's an interesting story over at the Free Thought Project about apparently Barack Obama going to be releasing some nonviolent drug offenders from prison. No one really saw this one coming, and at least I certainly didn't see it coming. We'll talk more about that when we get the chance. You can share your thoughts on anything you want to discuss. Derrick J. is with us here tonight, and somebody called recently, or we talked to someone recently, I don't know where we were, probably in the blur of Porkfest, about Liberland, the 3 square mile, 7 kilometer area of land between Serbia and Croatia, where there are a bunch of basically libertarian types who've sank their flag into the dirt in this plot of land that was supposedly unclaimed by both Croatia and Serbia. They called it Liberland and made headlines all around the world when this was done, what, 3 or 4 months ago now? It's not quite several months, but it's getting there. And ever since then, the Croatian government specifically has been pulling out all the stops to attempt to crush this nascent country from existing. They've arrested multiple people. Before we went to the Porcupine Freedom Festival about 2 weeks ago, there had been 24 arrests thus far of people who had attempted to go into Liberland. Whether they came from the Croatian side or the Serbian side, they were being arrested. Now, Croatia's supposed reason for arresting most of the batch was that they had crossed illegally from Croatia into Liberland, meaning that Croatia has determined that there will be certain legal checkpoints at which one can cross the border into Serbia, and no such legal checkpoint exists at the point where Liberland is on the Danube River, I believe.
Yeah.
So since they don't have an official government checkpoint there, they're saying it is illegal for you to cross into that other arbitrary plot of land if you cross at the point of Liberland. So,
wait a minute, that doesn't make any sense. Shouldn't they have a checkpoint if it's illegal for you to cross there?
Well, I guess they can have what they want.
Well, they don't want to actually provide customer service because, like we've said so many times here.
So wait a minute. So is it legal in the places where there is a checkpoint?
It would be legal to cross into
Serbia. But there isn't a checkpoint into Liberland.
Oh, got it. Okay. So it's just forbidden land.
Yeah, pretty much. That's the way they're acting. And now, Derrick J., you've got an update on this situation that has continued to develop. The president of Liberland, by the way, Vitjedlika or something like that.
Even when people go from Serbia into Liberland,
they're also being arrested.
They're being arrested by the Croatian police.
That's correct. And I'm not sure what they're being charged with.
They have no jurisdiction in this area.
Well, they're apparently trying to create some jurisdiction in this area by enforcing...
Then they should claim the land, but they weren't doing that.
Yeah, I don't know what it means to officially claim some land, but if you're going to go arresting people on it, I think that's some level of we're making a claim here on this thing now.
Yep.
That's just my interpretation, and I'm no legal scholar or expert, and there are some lawyers who are representing the folks from Liberland, and many of these cases have yet to really shake out. We've yet to really see what's going to happen ultimately, because I imagine they're planning on going to trial on all of these arrests. I don't think anybody's going to be taking a plea deal in these cases. But it's been fascinating to watch thus far. And Derrick J., there have been now more arrests. Is that right?
Yes. I have a press release from yesterday that came from the Liberland Settlement Association. And the headline reads, "Renewed Croatian Aggression in Liberland. Civilians and Red Cross Volunteers Forcibly Removed." And there are pictures and videos to confirm this.
If it wasn't enough of an international incident, now they've arrested the Red Cross. That just seems even more, for whatever reason, it seems even more egregious, right?
I think that the article gets into this, but that could be a violation of the Geneva Convention.
It could very well
be. So, I mean, this is a violation of international law if you play those games.
I'm pretty sure that arresting people for not passing out of your country into someplace that is not your country is probably also a violation of international law, right?
Well, these guys don't care. You'll watch the video. You can see how much they don't care.
All right.
After 2 weeks of relative calm in Liberland following the arrest of Danish-born Liberland citizen Erlik Hagensen, Croatian forces once again entered into Liberland territory today and abducted 4 people from Liberty Island. Among those abducted were aid workers representing the Liberland Red Cross. As in the past, members of the Croatian forces used excessive violence while removing the Liberlanders. The LSA, again, that's the Liberland Settlement Association, that's the group that's writing this article, was on hand to capture today's events on video. And there's a link to the video in their press release. It says, arriving from Serbia on the left bank of the Danube River, two LSA members approached Liberty Island while Croatian police boats gave chase. They were joined by several humanitarian workers from the Liberland Red Cross who were there to carry out their duties of observing and offering emergency aid if necessary. As shown in the video, all four of the non-combatants were removed with force, which included being dragged, pulled, and carried off of their sovereign soil. One of the settlers, a 41-year-old Brazilian native known as Crom, this is the most interesting part of the video. They don't get into it exactly in the press release, but he runs with a flag. He's got the like Liberland flag with him, and he's running right into the water so that the police have to chase him into the water to go get him. So it says one of the settlers, 41-year-old Brazilian native known as Crom, suffered severe violence at the hands of the Croatian forces. Crom can be seen in the video being manhandled and placed into a headlock before being thrown onto a police vessel.
Wow.
But he is the most courageous of the bunch, in my opinion, after seen the video.
These people are very smart not to engage in violence against these invaders, as much as they might want to. These people are breaking international law.
They are
invading a sovereign country, and they deserve to be repelled with force. And by that, I mean just send their bodies back to Croatia. That's what they deserve. But by doing such a thing would result in more force being ramped up by Croatia. Of course, these police officers have families. Those families think that what they're doing is completely legitimate because daddy's getting a government paycheck and he's got to pay the mortgage. Right. And all these things, these are all the excuses to these folks over there. These are brave, stalwart defenders of Croatia, keeping people that are just troublemaking rabble rousers from causing mischief. And that's what they think generally. So violence would be a bad choice here as much as people would like to see it happen.
I wonder how this is being reported in Croatia and if it is being reported at all. Because
more of your taxpaying money has been wasted bothering some people having a party on an island.
Yeah, that's just it. I mean, what kind of excuse could they really use for making these arrests? I mean, what would the official story, the cover for this actually be? They haven't committed any crimes. Nobody has harmed anybody else. If they're coming from Serbia, they can't legitimately be accused of crossing illegally from Croatia. So, I mean, what could they possibly trot out to justify this invasion? I'm just curious. I mean, if you know how to speak Croatian and you can go and search the Croatian media for us, please. I'm curious to know if there's a cover up or if this is even being discussed at all or what.
One would think they'd have to justify it somehow. Like, I would wonder what even the police reports say. Like, what is the charge exactly?
Resisting arrest.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's strange. They treat the land both like not their land by saying that people going into Liberland are crossing out of Croatia at a non-approved, checkpoint. And I think that that's a pretty legit charge. But then when people cross from the Serbian side by using boats to go onto Liberty Island, they go on to Liberty Island and take people off of there. I mean, they have just no legal legs to stand on this.
Just violence. That's the leg that they're
standing
on.
That's all there is for the state.
Right. Well, right, but that's
all these flag-waving people, and I don't care what country you're coming from, all you're doing is waving the flags of the most violent people around.
Once again, they are making it crystal clear. There's more from the press release?
Yes, what happened to these folks?
Yeah, let's find that out here coming up in moments. 855-450-FREE, the latest from Liberland. Coming up.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
Have you put off seeing the dentist because you can't afford to go? Are big dental bills taking a big toll on your wallet? Would you like to have dental insurance but think it's too expensive? If you answered yes to any of these questions, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company for a free information kit. See how you can help protect your teeth and your wallet by calling now. 1-800-496-5920. This is real dental insurance that can help cover over 300 procedures. Everything from cleanings and fillings to crowns and dentures. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. You can see any dentist you choose, and you'll never pay a deductible. Call in the next 10 minutes, and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-496-5920. That's 1-800-496-5920. 1-800-496-5920.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Derrick J.
And King Mark the First.
All right. Yeah, it is laughable, isn't it, Derrick? Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm. You don't have to talk about Liberland, but that's the topic that is on the table at the moment. We're going to get back into what happened when just recently, I don't know, was it yesterday, today?
Yesterday.
Yesterday, there were more arrests. There were 24 previously. Now we're up to at least 28.
Outrageous.
Yeah, and a lot of people have been arrested just trying to start their own country in basically an abandoned, unclaimed plot of land. We'll continue the story here in a moment. But wherever you are, whether you're in Croatia or Liberland or Japan or as long as you have access to Amazon, and there are Amazons all around the world, you can use Purse. Now, we talked with Andrew Lee, who's the CEO, one of the co-founders of Purse. We talked to him on Saturday night's show, and he told us that the average discount in the United States is 20%.
off of whatever it is you want to buy on Amazon, as long as you pay with Bitcoin through purse.freetalklive.com. But there are also other countries in which Amazon is operating. You know, we've got Amazon Canada, there's Amazon UK, there's a Japanese Amazon, there's a German Amazon. There's lots of different Amazons out there. If you can buy from Amazon, wherever you are in the world, you can use Purse. And you can go to purse.freetalklive.com. As long as you have Bitcoin, you can save up to 20% or more off of whatever it is you want to buy. It's not a scam. I've done it nearly two dozen times. I've saved over $500 on my purchases so far at Purse just by being willing to wait for a short period of time for someone to fill my order basically for me. You go to purse.freetalklive.com. You can watch the two-minute video or whatever. It's very short on how this all works. But it's very simple, and it works very well. I highly recommend it. Go and get signed up at purse.freetalklive.com. When you do that, Free Talk Live will get a very small portion of each of your purchases from that point forward. So that's actually a good URL that you can share with your friends, too. So what I've recommended is if you're using Purse and you get something through Purse and you get a sweet discount, 20%, 25%, whatever it is you decide, because you get to basically pick your discount, then you know, post up on social media. Hey, I got this new router at 20% off through purse.freetalklive.com by paying with Bitcoin. And then your family and friends will have a reason to check out Bitcoin first and foremost. And if they have some Bitcoin, they'll have a reason to spend it. Purse is really awesome. So check it out for yourself. Purse.freetalklive.com. Derrick J., let's continue with the press release from the Liberland Settlement Association. There was more violent arrests by the hands of these Croatian government goons. They were very, very mean and nasty, apparently, to the arrestees in this case.
So what happened to these people? Where are they now? Well, according to the press release, details are still unknown to the whereabouts or condition of the LSA and LLRC members. But from previous actions, it can be assumed that they were abducted across the Croatian border and into Croatia, where they are now being held. To date, there have been over 30 false arrests Liberland citizens outside the territory or jurisdiction of Croatia. Some LSA members have testified that they were denied food and water while in Croatian custody. The LSA reminds the international community of the following facts. Croatia has never claimed this land. It's an important one.
Yeah, it's not their land. Like, a country at the very least has to claim land for it to be theirs, right?
Yeah, I don't want
police. It's not theirs, but...
Yeah, I don't want German police around here telling me what to do. I expect, you know, that they, you know, I don't want American police telling me what to do either. Yeah. But you know what? The point
it's
I'm making
like
is like,
Canadians,
hey,
it's not like the Canadians are coming down here telling us what to do in New Hampshire.
Yeah, like, who are you? You know, what are you doing here?
Throwing
you don't
people to
here.
The ground and dragging them off sovereign soil.
Yeah, just following orders. All right, point
number
two. That's
the most dangerous word in the English, dangerous phrase in the English language.
Point number two, following a fact for the international community to keep in mind, this territory historically belonged to Serbia. So it's not even like it used to be Croatia's.
Oh, interesting.
This belonged to Serbia. Serbia released a statement declaring the, quote, newly formed state outside of the territory of Serbia. So this used to belong to Serbia. They're saying it's outside. It's official. The government has made this very clear. They've got a statement. Fourth, as no nation claims this land other than Liberland, Croatia does not have jurisdiction over this land, and it cannot be granted jurisdiction by Serbia or any other nation other than Liberland. The Liberland government has accepted and applied the Geneva Conventions and their added protocols. So I guess they're trying to get international recognition for their flag and territory. The Liberland Red Cross is the official national society of Liberland. Its volunteers are neutral observers and humanitarian workers who are protected persons under the Geneva Conventions, of which Croatia are signatory to. Now, that one sounds kind of gimmicky to me. Like, okay, we're going to play some international game of, like, laws on paper. Every citizen is a member of the Red Cross.
Wait, they didn't say every citizen.
Well,
was.
Okay, liberal.
They have a Red Cross, and they're not everyone was, right? Two members were Red Cross, two members were LSA, Liberland Settlement Association.
What it seems to me, and I'm speculating, but it seems like if I were a person who wanted to move to Liberland, I would be like, oh, yeah, I'm with the Red Cross because, Sure. I've got CPR training, and yeah, you're protected under the Geneva Convention. And so if they arrest me, it's going to be much worse for them, is what I presume. That's the idea.
Yeah.
So this seems like a strategy. It's definitely a legal strategy.
Right. Absolutely. And it's pretty smart.
Yeah.
I don't have a problem with strategies. I mean, these government agents have been calling themselves all kinds of pompous names since time immemorium. You might as well do it.
You're one to talk.
That's why I have declared myself to be King Mark the First, intergalactic ruler of everything.
Well, we'll see about that.
Yeah.
Contributions to the
but
LSA.
But I claim it. These people have no more legitimacy than I do.
Well, they're smart. They're raising money in Bitcoin.
Yeah,
they've got a Bitcoin legal fund, which you can find on their website. It's, you know, easy to find this press release, Liberland.
It's hard to get somebody to donate to a legal fund. Haven't you found that?
I don't know. I've done it. I've done it with some success. Raising money, telling people what it goes for, and if you connect the dots to why it matters to them, then people are willing to give.
Okay.
It's true. Of course, you were only trying to raise $2,500, which is a little bit
I don't know how much these people are trying to raise.
That doesn't even pay an attorney for more than 10 hours in most cases.
Typically, yeah.
You've got an attorney who's giving you a real good deal on your gun case, which is a whole other matter.
Like one of the best gun attorneys in the country happens to have taken a liking to you and your case.
Aw, that was nice. Yeah, I don't mind plugging him. His name's Evan Knappen, and he's done great work for me, so I've been very happy.
He's done
great work for many other people as well.
He's only really licensed in New Hampshire and New Jersey, is that right?
That's my understanding.
He's the one who represented that.
It's so weird, too, because like, talk about gun freedoms. Like, you couldn't be on polar opposites.
That's why he moved. he moved for the Free State Project, I think, before Ian and I did.
Yeah, he was at one time the vice president of the Free State Project.
Yeah.
So we'll come back here.
He represented that guy that was found with the black powder pistol
in Jersey.
Yeah.
And those charges were dropped.
They were dropped afterwards. Yep.
Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We can talk more about Liberland on the way here. Plus, will scores of nonviolent drug offenders be released by Barack Obama? Will he be pardoning people? Is this for real? 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
If you're looking for work, it's a process of elimination, and you're trying not to be eliminated. So here's a tip for making the cut, and this might seem subtle, but to the person interviewing you, it's not. There is a world of difference between applicants who convey, "I need a job," and those who simply ooze, "I want to work," especially in these lean times when many you're competing with will seem desperate in "I'll take anything" mode. If you convey specific interest in this job at this company, you will be conspicuous. Thus, the value of going to school on the company you're applying to before the interview. With money and attention so tight now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips for job seekers and everyone else, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
And I use the downsizeddc.org system for responding to my Congress critters and talking to the thieves and liars and despots in Washington, D.C. And in these letters, they outline the issue for me. Then they flush it down the toilet. And it's so demeaning.
Yeah.
They just don't care what I think. I can tell them,
he'll pretend like he cares if he's trying to get elected.
They only care what you think if you're giving them a check with, five digits on it. Then you might be able to get them to do something.
Yeah.
But that's just one senator among the 535 disgusting, dishonorable thieves. What's a guy to do? These lobbying groups, they run Washington. Washington has been taken over. It does not belong to the American people. It doesn't do anything for the American people. It is a bad, bad place.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you can dial in and join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm, and you can join us and talk about whatever's on your mind. We've been discussing Liberland, and we will continue to do that here in moments. And, of course, you can also join us over at freetalklive.com and become an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. It's $5 a month. It's a way for you to get behind Free Talk Live and support what we're doing by helping us get on more radio stations around the country and bring more listeners to the ideas of freedom, also on our internet streams and via satellite. We just recently expanded back out to cover Africa, a good portion of Africa. It's hard to cover Africa with one satellite, but we did get a good swath of the east-west central Africa, and it's great to be back on there, and it's thanks to about 56 donors. So thank you to everybody who made that possible for us. I really appreciate it. I'm glad people share the vision of getting the ideas of liberty back on the airwaves in Africa. So if you want to help us with that kind of thing, you can go to amp.freetalklive.com, and you'll get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, the amp-only podcast and forum, amp-only Facebook group. It's all there at amp.freetalklive.com. Derrick J., you've been telling us about this press release from the Liberland Settlement Association. It's a group of folks who are geared towards making Liberland a reality, this place that has been chosen between Croatia and Serbia, a 3-square-mile plot of land that is essentially, it's a swamp. It's kind of in the middle of the Danube River, and there's a portion of it that's over on, the Croatian side as well. So it's like an island and portion of what might have been Croatia, but actually never was, according to the press release.
It was part of Serbia.
Part of Serbia, and then they gave it up, during the conflict at some point that they had?
Well, I don't know if it was ever clear when they gave it up. Mm-hmm. There was a dispute between the two countries for decades, and now the government of Serbia has made it official. They do not own that property.
Recently, they remade that official.
Yes.
Okay. Just to clarify.
They clarified.
Got it.
Well, the Danube River moves back and forth, and this piece of land at one point
Based on tides or whatever, or what?
Just not tides. I mean, just rivers move.
Okay.
If they're not walled in and have oyster beds or whatever holding them in, then they're going to move. And that's what's happened with in this circumstance. This was actually Serbian land at one point, but it's just sort of an agreement, and there's this, sort of unused land there.
Okay. So what else do we need to know, Derrick J? Right now, the people who are arrested for trying to go to Liberland, there's another 4. We're now over 30 people who have been arrested thus far, or at least 30 people who've been arrested. And these 4 have disappeared. Nobody knows exactly where they're being held. They presume they're in some sort of Croatian jail in advance of whatever court hearing they're going to have, whatever arraignment-style thing they have in Croatia. but they haven't been heard from yet.
And what's the source?
The source is the Liberland Settlement Association. They've put out their own press release.
That's all you got out there.
It could be published. It's at both medium.com and at liberlandpress.com.
That's the best we got. There's nobody else out there that's, you know, in any kind of independent journalist or whatever that we've heard of. So
yeah, Free Talk Live is covering this story far more than any other news agency out there.
We're not a news agency, but yes, I see what you're saying. More than news agencies are covering.
I mean, you know, now and then we pass as a news agency. It's not like we've never broken stories before.
Yeah, that's true.
And when I'm in court and people ask me what press I'm with, I say Free Talk Live. So why not?
We're nominally the press, but we have the advantage of sort of being able to commentate on the news as we see it, too.
Can't anyone say they're with Free Talk Live, too, as press? Isn't that like...
You're a producer.
Anybody who can call in.
Anybody can call in as a producer of content on Free Talk Live.
Yeah.
That's absolutely true.
All right. So the other thing you got to know is...
If anybody contacts me, I say, we have a lot of producers.
Liberland Settlement Association is their Facebook page. And so I expect that's probably the best place to go for new information. If something
I looked there
develops.
And they didn't have it.
They didn't have what?
Liberland SA dot something did not have this press release.
If you want me to spell it out, it's facebook.com/Liberland Settlement Association.
No, I'm talking about it. Liberland SA's S.
What is that?
A. I don't know.
Liberland
he's saying go to their Facebook page, Mark, if you want the latest information.
LiberlandSA.org. It hasn't been updated since June the 14th.
That's the problem, man. I mean, everybody's on Facebook. What Derrick is saying is not to go to their website, but to go to their Facebook page to get the latest information.
Yes. And if you want, if we haven't made it clear, they spell it out at the bottom of their press release. They say Liberland Settlement Association is a Swiss NGO,
non-governmental organization,
dedicated to the settlement and development of Liberland, and open to members from around the world.
So what else do we need to know?
That's it. That's all the info they've got. They've got for press inquiries, they've got information there, but they've got a legal defense fund. I think that's the most important actionable item that listeners could take is to support.
Or you can go down and get arrested.
Or you could go join and reinforce these gutsy activists.
Well, because I mean, what we know from our experience, Derrick, is that you can only push civil disobedience so far.
Well, you run out of steam. 30 arrests in. I don't know how many people they've got in this Liberland place, but I can't imagine it's many more than 30.
Right. Well, actually, from what I understand, they have had dozens of people at their parties. They'll come in
dozens.
People will come in from different countries for short periods of time to visit. Liberland.
And similar with New Hampshire. I mean, a lot of people claim New Hampshire their home in spirit, and they don't live here all year, you know? So how many people in Liberland are just there for the fair weather days, and they don't want to live in a tent?
Yeah, most people are just down, I think, to visit and to check it out.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean they can't go and get arrested. I mean, if you're in Europe and, you know, you want to put your body on the line, throw your body into the gears of the state, then certainly this is probably one of the best opportunities to do so.
They kind of need that because...
You could go to prison.
Well, they seem to be being more gentle on people they have not arrested yet. So,
are there people who've been arrested more than once?
They're threatening that things would be bad if you get arrested twice, basically.
That's what I'm saying. So that's why, what I was getting at when I was saying that you can only go so far with civil disobedience. Once you get a record, then the next time you get arrested, and Derrick, you and I have been arrested multiple times, but the next time you get arrested, that gets more difficult, because then you've got a rap sheet, and then the judge will look at you in a different manner, and, now you're a repeat offender.
Well, escalating the force works. I mean, it has the intended effect that state agents want it to have.
It's a deterrent.
It quelches the activism,
But
guys are speaking as both civil disobedient activists that have basically been stopped by, what happens the next time.
I've been stopped.
Well, I can't say I've been stopped. I'll still continue to record when I'm told to to stop recording. I will still push the boundaries in a lot of ways.
I'm complying with the new law in New Hampshire about not being able to conceal carry. I have to unload my magazine every time I step in the car just because I know I want to comply with this. I don't want to get arrested again. I don't want to have all that nonsense.
So having more people who are willing to take these risks is what they need, in my opinion, if they want to continue this track that they're on of, hey, we're going to keep going and sinking our flag into this ground.
It's funny, they say, if you don't like your government, go someplace else. And when people go someplace else,
look
the government
happens.
Goes and drags them off of it.
Hey, you can't do that. Don't stop running with that flag.
These people are on a sandbar trying to get away from the government. And the government is coming on to the sandbar
with
that they
boats.
don't claim, dragging them off.
Yeah, that's what's so funny to me. It's not like they homesteaded some castle or palace or somewhere. They're like in the least desirable part of the world, probably. If any place you want to...
Well, there's always Antarctica.
Well, yeah.
It's a mosquito-filled swamp is what it is.
I don't know if
great.
There's mosquitoes there, but...
Yes, there are.
There are, okay. Yeah.
Sounds great.
So thank you for the update on that, Derrick J. We are going to continue
welcome.
To follow the Liberland case of... I'm sure I'm mispronouncing his name, but I'm doing it better than before. Jedlicka, I think was how you pronounce his last name. We were saying Jedlicka or something as we would
I'm
as Americans.
I'm mispronouncing it better than I was before.
Jedlicka. Was not able to go to the Porcupine Freedom Festival this year, but as I understand it, there was some sort of presentation there about Liberland by one of their supporters.
Yes.
And I just think it's an exciting thing. I think it's probably the most exciting thing for freedom that's happening in the Europe sort of region. Obviously, the Free State Project is the most exciting thing, in my opinion, in general. But these guys really have something neat happening over there, and it's worth paying attention to. So, if you've got some news you want to share with us, maybe we haven't heard yet, you're welcome to join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. And it looks like there may actually be some good news, something good to say about Barack Obama. Coming up here, you're saying no, Derrick Chase?
No.
Not what it looks like? All right.
You, me, and BTC is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
We're sitting down with Mr. Jason King. If you want to f*** with the government, feed homeless people, man.
Jeffrey Tucker.
What's possible in the Bitcoin space? It sounds a little like science fiction, but if you wait enough time, it becomes a reality.
Angela Keaton from antiwar.com.
This is what the United States does. Involves killer robots. For Bitcoiners, this is a way to get around. That.
Subscribe at youmeandbtc.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
All right, so suddenly Walmart, eBay, Amazon, everybody wants to ban the rebel flag. Well, the rebel flag is an important part of American history. The rebel flag is still a long-standing symbol of Southern pride and Southern heritage. So if the big retailers want to play into political correctness and try to deny the history of America, let them. Go to rflags.com, that's R like rebel, R, the letter R, rflags.com. Get your rebel flag before they actually do outlaw the things, huh? rflags.com, that's rflags.com. Go now.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
Hi, I'm Derrick J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derrick J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course you can join us here, toll-free number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, it's Ian.
Derrick J.
And King Mark the First.
Check out Derrick J's website. It's thederrickj.com. That's where you'll get lots more Derrick J.
Yes.
Audio and video form.
Yes. Still uploading things from Porkfest.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So if you missed Porkfest, see it through my eyes.
Yes.
At thederrickj.com.
And get Derrick J on other shows like Freedom Fiends and Cop Block Radio. Flaming Freedom.
And a brand new one, maybe never to be done again, but it was called The Dawn of Freedom. It was a very special late night event crossover show with the School Sucks Project and other podcasts.
Was this the one that went for like 4 or 5 hours or something during Porkfest?
Yes, it went 4.5 hours after an episode of Freedom Fiends.
You guys didn't finish till the sun came up, that kind of thing?
That's right. That's why it's called The Dawn of Freedom.
That was cool. I was there to see the beginning of it, and then I went to bed.
Well, the idea is that anyone could do a Dawn of Freedom episode as long as they stay up all night talking about liberty into a podcast.
Cool. And that's available now, or will
it
be
is,
available?
Yeah, it is available. Part one is available. The other three parts will come out later.
TheDerrickJ.com. All right, so we're talking about Liberland, and coming up we'll talk about this Obama supposedly releasing people from prison, nonviolent drug offenders. But I had asked on the air, and we were talking about how our listeners can be producers for Free Talk Live, and Nathan, one of our producers, has sent, Nathan in Texas, he sent me a link to a Croatian website, which actually has news about the arrests in Liberland that we were just talking about,
because
I was wondering aloud, what's the news like? How are they reporting this in Croatia, if it's being reported at all? And apparently they have been reporting on it. At least they reported on the most recent arrests, and presumably if they've reported on those, they probably have reported on some others.
Do you have got a translate there?
I have Google Translate. It's rough, but I'll go through it here. It's relatively short. The article's relatively short.
They've got a flashy picture there, right? Yeah. An action shot with like splashing water and a police boat.
This must be the guy you were talking about.
It looks like Miami Vice.
He was running out into
Daniel
the water.
Vice.
Yeah, that's Crom.
Right. You were explaining this guy
He's
from
a Brazilian
Brazil.
Guy, yeah.
Ran out into the water carrying the Liberland flag in an attempt to sort of make the bureaucrats have to get wet, I guess, to make the
he
arrest.
He was successful in that.
Yeah, I would say they're in not quite waist-deep water, but it's definitely up to their upper legs. So
it couldn't have been pleasant.
Here is the story from, let me see if I can try this, Glas Slavonje, or something like that. Invasion of foreign nationals in the area of self-proclaimed state Liberland not subside. On Sunday evening, the police and the... Stop me if you need further interpretation.
I got it. It hasn't subsided.
Right. They put invasion in quotes. On Sunday evening, the police in the forest area above Siga, outside of the border crossing at illegal crossing of the state border between Croatian and Serbian, found by nationals of Brazil and the Netherlands and two citizens of the Czech Republic. Those were the people that were arrested. So the Brazilian, the Netherlands person, and two people from the Czech Republic. But the party is not so easy to surrender to Croatian authorities, and the officers had to harness all their forces to detain them.
On Monday, four men brought the magistrate judge in Beli Manastir, where they were expected to pay a fine. I suspect they did not pay that fine, but it would be interesting to find out more. Croatia, on the website of LiberlandPress.com, called aggressor who forcibly takes civilians and volunteers of the Red Cross with the so-called Free Island. They're saying that Croatia was called the aggressor on the Liberland website.
Great.
There is there it is stated that it was the Danes and not the Dutchmen. The Facebook page.
It's the Danes, not the Dutchmen.
The Facebook page.
What does that even mean?
I don't know what
that means.
I don't
know what it means either. But I love it.
It's Google Translate. The Facebook page Liberlandia or Liberlanda even published photos, arrests man who struggled as far as he knew. And run three and run great. Three Croatian police officers. Some and
no,
running.
There were two. How many police officers? It said there were three.
Well, it says they had to marshal all their forces against them.
Oh wow! Okay,
all three of them.
Some and
excellent. This is going to work, actually.
Some and running through the water and carrying the flag Liberlandia. However, the policemen finally managed to overcome and taken to a police station.
Whew.
Others were arrested while in Serbia, arrived in boats. Facebook page Liberlanda collected more 164,000 people accompany it. I think that means 164,000 likes, perhaps?
That sounds like it, yeah.
And the comments of foreigners who have believed in this phantom state are very interesting.
Well, I don't think that I'm not surprised the Croatian press decides to call it a phantom state. As long as they acknowledge that this ground isn't claimed by Croatia, then then everybody's on the same page. Because the Croatian police just went after some people who supposedly illegally crossed from Serbia into an area that the Croatian police don't control. That is
appear to control it. They're arresting people. So they appear to have some level of control over this property that they don't supposedly claim.
Some whacked out Mountie who's drunk off his butt can come down here and put a gun to my head. That doesn't make him anything but a freaking criminal. And it might make him an invader and possibly it could be a war crime.
So they're talking about the Liberland Facebook page, and they go on to say in the final segment here, in fact, after the publication of the text, which included photos and arrests, some of the comments are, quote, Croatian aggression must stop, unquote, and, quote, Liberland need an army, unquote. Among the revelations, there was one in which the self-proclaimed president of Vit Jedlica met with well-known architects to discuss possible cooperation in the field of Liberland S. Lasik. I don't know what that actually means, that last word.
No.
But there you go. That's what the Croatian press apparently has to say. The Glas Savonji is what they have to say about the Liberland arrests.
Hilarious.
So, not really taking, I guess the political statement they're making there is that this is a phantom country, and they are using, they did use quotes around invasion, because obviously they're not invading Croatia. Who's being invaded here? It's Liberland that's being invaded by the Croatian police.
At the very least, the Croatian police are taking control of an area that they don't have any legal jurisdiction over.
The headline says they robbed the police, but they didn't talk about that in the article, or maybe it was a mistranslation.
Yeah, who knows what this actually says, but the translated headline is, Romp around Liberlandia, colon, arrested Brazilian, Dutch, and two Czechs, comma, robbed the police.
Did they? Did they know? That seems like a very important detail. I would like to know.
Maybe they robbed them of their dignity by forcing them to run out into the water and get their pants wet.
They did that.
Yeah. Well, good job, guys. Yeah, I support that.
Yeah, it's awesome. I will have to check this video out. You say you've watched it, yes?
Yeah.
Derrick Chang?
Yeah, it's funny. I mean, as funny as it can be to see good people get arrested, but, you know.
I got to say, in Derrick J's victimless crime spree, the funniest part to me is when that pudgy sheriff is chasing you down the street.
I like that, too.
It's just hilarious. Yeah, I mean, they should be playing the Benny Hill song there. And it's just, I don't know.
All right, so Barack Obama, the headlines are saying that he may be releasing scores of nonviolent drug offenders from prison. The story written over at thefreethoughtproject.com. Matt Agarist is the writer. Washington, D.C., the timeless words of Joe Rogan, which are the following, quote, Prison is for rapists, thieves, and murderers. If you lock someone up for smoking a plant that makes them happy, you're the effing criminal, unquote. The timeless words of Joe Rogan seem to be taking their toll on the consciences of American politicians. To kidnap and lock people in a cage for a personal choice and action that harms no one is an evil act. Some politicians are figuring this out, or at least pandering to public demand. Either way, the result is the same. Despite largely continuing the war on drugs and drastically increasing raids on medical marijuana facilities, as compared to his predecessor, Barack Obama has somehow managed to dupe people into thinking that he was pro-legalized pot.
Yeah.
Over the years, Obama has blown a lot of smoke, pun intended, when it came to his views on the war on drugs. He's played Mr. Nice Guy while his heavily militarized government task forces have laid waste to the rights and property of peaceful people trying to help their fellow man by growing medical marijuana. Under Obama, police in America, through the federal 1033 program, have acquired MRAPs, grenade launchers, and even Apache attack helicopters. Most of those have been used enforcing immoral and unethical drug laws. However, no one, not even the glorious dictator on high, can stop an idea whose time has come. The people have spoken, and politicians who continue to call for the imprisonment of nonviolent individuals for their personal choices are being exposed for the vile and obstinate tyrants that they are.
Oh, please. This is so exaggerated. He says politicians are changing their minds on this issue. Which ones? I'd like to know. You know, what politicians have spoken out against caging peaceful people? That would be pretty radical to me. And I don't think Obama's the politician.
They're going to cite the New York Times here as their source about the claim that Barack Obama may be pardoning people. Alleged nonviolent drug offenders. We'll talk more about it. You're saying this is
straight from the White House propaganda mill.
Yeah, all right. We'll talk about it coming up here in moments. Hour number two on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, freshening of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded
or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting?
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Toll House Refrigerated Cookie Dough. Who would you bake some love for? Find fun and easy baking ideas at tollhouse.com. Kids love doing arts and crafts projects, especially when you join in. Try channeling all that artistic energy into the kitchen and bake up some creative treats together. Think of your art supplies as the frosting, sprinkles, and decorating gels, and use cookies or cupcakes as your canvas. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, July 6th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.59 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,165 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $274. Antiwar.com reports Yemeni state media reported a flurry of Saudi airstrikes yesterday in the Hajja province, slamming the Ahim marketplace and killing at least 30 civilians and wounding an unspecified number of others. Locals confirmed the attacks but could not confirm the final death toll, saying Houthi forces had quickly moved in and blocked off the marketplace, ferrying ambulances back and forth to take the wounded to nearby hospitals. Yemen's Houthis and its military allies reportedly retaliated against the military airport in the southern city of Najran, reportedly destroying a tank and armored vehicle. One Saudi soldier was slain and dozens of others were wounded. Neither Saudi officials nor their allies in the former Hadi government addressed the attacks in Hajja. Those strikes killing massive number of civilians have been common throughout the Saudi war against Yemen. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports after weeks of posturing and refusal by Greece to accept fiscal terms necessary to bail it out of deep fiscal trouble, Greek voters on Sunday effectively told creditors the same thing. Thanks, but no thanks. As Greece continues to struggle to try to stay afloat amid its serious debt crisis, billions of dollars in financial relief offered by international creditors were rejected by a highly anticipated voter referendum on Sunday. Sunday's referendum on the bailout terms skewed heavily in the no column, exactly as Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras hoped, with the vast majority of the votes siding with the leader's Syriza party. Needing to pay a $1.7 billion payment to the International Monetary Fund by the end of June, but not having the cash to do so, Athens engaged in numerous negotiations over the last 4 months, hoping to strike a deal to unlock the remainder of $7 billion in relief cash previously granted by the organization. However, demands by creditors for Athens to cut government spending in exchange for the relief proved to be the deal-breaker. Tsipras reportedly rejected the offer, saying the cuts would affect Greek workers' wages and state-funded pensions. Last week, Greece defaulted on the loans, and Tsipras, not wanting to uniformly reject help without public support, ordered Sunday's referendum. By late Sunday, 60% had voted against the IMF's bailout terms. German Chancellor Angela Merkel and French President François Hollande spoke by telephone Sunday night and agreed the Greek voters' decision must be respected. A spokesman for the German government said the chancellor and the president are in favor of calling for a summit of Eurozone heads of state and government heads on Tuesday. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a Maine man died during a 4th of July celebration on Saturday night when he tried to launch a firework from the top of his head and it exploded, killing him instantly, according to police. Devin Staples of Calais, Maine, was drinking and celebrating the holiday in a friend's backyard when he placed the firework mortar tube on his head around 10 p.m., according to Stephen McLaughlin, a spokesman for the State Department of Public Safety. McLaughlin said it was unclear whether the firework was already lit or whether Staples lit it once it was on his head. He was killed instantly when it exploded. The tube Staples was using was a reusable mortar shell, according to McLaughlin, but said investigators did not know what type of firework he was attempting to shoot. Maine has allowed the sale of fireworks since lawmakers repealed a 60-year-old ban on them in 2011. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Reflecting on the persistent troubles it caused his sibling during childhood, local doctor Daniel Barrett told reporters this week about his average-looking brother, Kevin, who first inspired him to be a cosmetic surgeon.
As a kid, I remembered thinking that there was nothing I could do for Kevin. Watching someone you really love and care about suffer from a weak jawline or unsymmetrical features It had a major impact on me.
And in this week's local news, a community theater gives the part of Blanche DuBois to Kathy f***ing Hamilton. In other news, a moviegoer manages to sneak candy past a teenage usher earning $7 an hour. A new app matches you with others in the vicinity who wasted $2.99 on the same app. And a Roman centurion crawling out of a New York City manhole cover is in for one wacky adventure. Having graciously spread my knowledge to the uneducated masses, I now return to the stately, elegant ranks of News Announcer Society. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We've got time for you to join us here and bring up anything you want to discuss. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, we'll get into this story here from the Free Thought Project. They're citing the New York Times, claiming Barack Obama might be releasing dozens of federal prisoners that have been locked up on nonviolent drug offenses. But Derrick J., you're saying this isn't all it appears that it is. You've already looked into this story, and we'll talk more
this
about
that. This here yarn's a bunch of horse pucky.
All right, we'll see. I was excited there for a moment, but you brought me back to reality.
Yeah, my eye roll is almost audible.
All right, we'll get into that. But first, Teet is on the line in Pennsylvania. You're on Free Talk Live, Teet.
Hey, guys. How are you doing today?
Good.
Hey.
You're on the air. Go ahead.
Okay, great. Hey, by the way, love the show, and certainly thanks for the hookup for the Pro XDN with the code FGL50. Appreciated that.
Oh, of course.
So, by the way, you know, last week you guys had sort of got, Mark and Ian had gotten into a little tiff about memes, but I just want to clarify what a meme is.
And tell him how I'm right.
Right, I will tell you how you're right, Mark. So,
Thank you.
So a meme is an idea that is shared and passed back and forth. And the easiest way to think of it is sort of a running joke that evolves over time. And probably the simplest example is if you have a pet, you might have a name for your pet. Maybe you have a roommate or a girlfriend you live with. And that pet's nickname changes every week or so as you tack on something new about it. Like, for example, you know, I've got a dog, and my dog's name changes from, you know, beans and rice to just beans to beaners to beanie weenie, and it just keeps going and going. Not unlike what you see, let's say, with Grumpy Cat, where people take the Grumpy Cat and use it as a running joke and mix that with other running jokes, maybe mm-hmm. with Gene Wilder or something else. So just want to clarify that. So that's it.
Do you get the idea now, Ian?
So it's something that changes over time. A meme cannot stay constant.
A meme, think of it in spoken word. Even let's say in the early 80s, they had sort of the Valley Girl speak where somebody would say things like it's something's totally gross or mm-hmm. it's grody or grody to the max.
Gotta be with a fork.
It evolves slowly over time.
Have we looked
now,
up?
They're certainly used in practical application. They're certainly used online as images, but you see over time is images actually start getting mixed together as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So
a picture with a
image
with Scumbag Steve on it is one of these commonly seen memes, for lack of a better term. That is actually not a meme. That is just sort of the offspring of a meme.
It's a meme. It's the baseline upon which, it's a palette upon which people, or a blank canvas upon which people paint.
But what you're saying is,
the same canvas.
So, but each of the canvases are part of the larger meme. They themselves are not individual memes. So one picture that goes viral isn't a meme simply because it's gone viral. That's just a portion of a meme?
Well, a picture going viral, let's say if there's somebody has a spectacular sunset and it goes viral, and that's not necessarily...
No, I meant a picture with like the words on it, the kind of the classic thing. There's these things online, meme creators, where you can take a picture, you can upload it, and then you put the capital letter words on it, which, you know.
Always impact font and terrible punctuation.
Yeah, when I say a picture, that's what I meant, is one of those things. When one of those goes viral, that's not actually the meme. The meme is the larger picture or whatever that's behind that, that has sort of fed into that.
People have screwed up the definition, and they've sort of I'm trying to think of the right phrase here. You know how somebody says, you know, I want to let's go out for Starbucks, and they say, well, let's just go to the coffee shop, and say, yeah, that's what I meant. Or, hey, can you hand me a Kleenex? And you mean just the tissue? Or, hey, these memes are funny. You mean just that one picture that you're talking about with Scumbag Steve on it, or the one with the grumpy cat? Because memes are not just limited to pictures on the internet. They're
sure, memes are an idea, right?
Yes. Ideas,
but Mark, weren't
shared.
You telling me that the picture itself was not the meme?
The picture itself isn't the meme.
But so, with the words on it, isn't it a meme because it's an idea?
No. So Scumbag Steve image. Let's go back to what you're talking about. This is the guy with the terrible
sideways cap,
Versace clothes or whatever the heck he's wearing,
peeking through the doorway or whatever.
And you know, now if somebody says, "Hey, come take a look at this Scumbag Steve meme," it's actually an image that is, you know, sort of using the meme. Does that make sense? So the idea is Scumbag Steve and what he's about.
Yeah.
And then the verbiage makes a specific image using that particular meme.
So what
meme.
Do you call that then? What do you call the thing that comes from
it's
the meme?
It's an image or a picture or a graphic.
Why can't that be a meme,
Yeah, why
too?
Can't you call that a meme? Like, hey, we need some listeners to make a meme of Mark freaking out.
No, it's not a meme until it catches on and it's used and shared. It's otherwise, it's just you with your one idea.
But how many shares does it have to get to become a meme?
It has to be duplicated. It's not the shares, Ian. Look, you can have a picture of you standing around in your silly rainbow hat and a tutu, all right, is just a picture of you in a tutu. Yeah. It is not a meme. If I write letters on it, look at this braying jackass.
This is stupid. Who cares?
The words matter, and Free Talk Live is...
Well, these are the meme purists who are trying to save the original version of meme.
Why do you care?
Why do I care? Well... You guys have just gone through it for, I don't know, 10 minutes on
I know, but I'm frustrated now. I'm like, I don't even care. You know, it's a meme. You can call it a meme if it's got words or text or if it has just a picture.
I think it's a meme if it gets shared around, right? Like if two people share it, then it's a meme, right? Or do you have to have 200,000 to share it?
Guys, words matter.
Okay, then let's use a definition. I've got one. Would you like to hear it? Meme definition, according to Google, noun, an element of culture or system of behavior that may be considered to be passed from one individual to another by non-genetic means, especially imitation. And the example that it gives is a humorous image, video, piece of text, etc., that is copied, often with slight variations, and spread rapidly by internet users.
It's the variation part of that that's really important. Now look,
so if someone makes a second Scumbag Steve, then he's become a meme?
That's when it's a meme. That's what we've been trying to say all along. So the reason it matters is because you have to have words to describe things. If you don't have words to describe things, we're all reduced to and whacking each other over the head.
Yeah, but everybody knows what a meme is. It's just the thing that gets passed around that's funny on the internet.
I'm
that's
terribly
what a meme
sorry
is now.
That the
that's
world
what it
is full
now.
Of people that don't understand what
you
the
guys are like the people
are.
Trying to save the word anarchist to me. That's all this is. Thanks, Teet, for the call. Appreciate your thoughts. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Your word meme is dead. It now means whatever people are passing around that's fun on the internet.
Fine.
And I mean, that's what it is, right? Change over time. Like words, the meanings of words will change.
Yes.
So
you know what spam
used
to be? Spam used to be going into a message form and saying the same thing over and over again.
No, that's flooding.
That's what it's called now. You know why? Because some jackass began using the term in a different way.
Spam used to be that thing that comes in a can.
Yes, it did.
Spam was in a can originally. Spam is unwanted commercial postings, typically.
Are you familiar with Monty Python? Spam, 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 spam.
It's a song.
Saying the same thing over and over again.
Oh.
That's what spam used to be. It wasn't flooding. We had to come up with the term flooding because some jackhole began using the term spam in an incorrect way. And now spam means exactly as you said, unwanted commercial communication.
That's right.
So
that's
big
what it means
deal.
Now.
Now we all know what it means. Words change over time.
Yeah,
and
they do.
That wasn't even very long. It was like one lifetime.
It's the internet.
Our toll-free number
it's
tonight.
It's a lifetime.
855-450-FREE. So I still maintain that the picture that the Free Talk Live listeners made, you've got this crew of guys that are making, maybe some gals, I don't know who all is involved, but there's some listeners who have made memes, for lack of a better term, images with words on them that convey an idea.
I like
memes. And they get passed around. Just because there's only one image, there's this one image that you made with the American flag at the bottom and the rebel flag on the top, and yep. some stuff was typed on it, and that was shared, what, a couple million times or something ridiculous
some
like
ridiculous
that?
Number.
I mean, that sounds like it has become a meme, right? You know, is it only a meme when somebody says, oh, I like that picture, and then they put their own text on top of it? Well, that's silly.
With a rigorous definition, yes.
That's silly. 855-450-FREE. If it's an idea that gets passed around on the internet, then I think it's a meme. You can share your thoughts, though, and you can bring up anything you want. Barack Obama releasing people from prison. Is this for real? It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And now we're extending our in-home trial to let you try Listen Clear risk-free for a full 45 days with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. Call now, 1-800-956-9829. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your extended 45-day in-home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-956-9829. That's 1-800-956-9829. 1-800-956-9829.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
We're back now with more Free Talk Live. What is it really going to happen that Barack Obama is going to release dozens of nonviolent drug offenders from prison? That's what the New York Times is claiming here, according to the freethoughtproject.com. We'll tell you more about that coming up. Also, one of our last callers mentioned ProXPN, and that is something that you can do to protect yourself on the internet. You can actually encrypt your internet connection so your own internet service provider won't know what you're doing online anymore. And if they don't know what you're doing, they can't tell anybody what you're doing. Like, you know, sell your personal information to corporations. They might be logging all of the websites you visit, the search terms you enter. Maybe they'll turn that information over to the government too. You can prevent that from happening. You can also stop criminals from sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets with ProXPN. It's a great little app you can get for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, as well as Linux. You go through the easy setup, get connected, and you'll be protected from the prying and spying. Plus, you can get their premium account at 50% off the regular monthly price when you get their annual account with code FTL50, and that breaks the price down to around $5 a month. FTL, like Free Talk Live, 50, as in 50% off. And that, by the way, that discount is good for the lifetime of your account, no matter which account that you choose. It's the premium account giving you unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and they don't keep records of your online habits at all. So use promo code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Again, proxpn.com/FTL. I want to welcome our newest radio affiliate. Just confirmed, they are on the air tonight. KTOX 1340 in Needles, California, the tri-state's talk leader. They're right down there. They're in the corner between Nevada and California and Arizona. And so, welcome.
The tri-state
aboard.
Area?
Well, there are a lot of tri-state areas out there. So, this is one of them. And so, welcome to KTOX listeners. We are your afternoon drive hosts right now. We're actually on the East Coast where we're doing the show live from. But you're welcome to participate because you are actually listening live. So, it makes it easy to join the show here. And you can do that by calling us toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we've got Skype, which is, of course, the best way, in my opinion, to contact the show. Skype username is lrn.fm. You just send a contact request real fast. We'll approve it. And then after that, you can call us easily from that point forward. So with you in the studio tonight, it's Ian here.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
Derrick, you're very skeptical about this story from the Free Thought Project.
Yeah.
They're saying the New York Times is reporting the following, quote, "Sometime in the next few weeks, aides expect President Obama to issue orders freeing dozens of federal prisoners locked up on nonviolent drug offenses."
Let's stop right there. Expect to happen? This is already not news.
That's true.
Show me when he's done something.
Yeah, good point. All right, I'll give you that, no doubt. "With the stroke of his pen," says the Times, "he will probably commute more sentences at one time than any president has in nearly half a century."
Weak. And it doesn't put into perspective that Jimmy Carter, what is it called, where you pardoned all of the draft dodgers. All of them. Not 80.
Really?
Yeah. Not scores. All
of
them.
I didn't know that.
In one stroke of his pen. So for them to exaggerate and say, oh, you know, all these people got freedom. I know it's a different kind of freedom, but there have been presidents who have done much more.
Well, I guess, can you pardon somebody who hasn't been convicted of something? I mean, the draft dodgers you're talking about. Was he just sort of...
I don't know
Nixon.
If I'm using the...
Yes, they can.
I don't know if I'm using the correct terminology, but you get the gist.
I believe you can.
"The expansive use of his clemency power is part of a broader effort by Obama to correct what he sees as the excesses of the past."
Well, this is... hold on. This is a meme that's gone on with Obama for quite some time. Obama, Barack Obama is the greatest president ever. Like, this is the... I mean... Really? We've had 44 of them, and this is the greatest one? Because it hasn't felt like the greatest president yet. I've sat here for the last 7 years or so, and I'll admit, you know, during, you know, some times of some presidents out there that we've had in the recent history that have been turned out to be, you know, the history has looked well upon them. That I've been like, eh, you know, I didn't think they were so impressive. But I don't think, you know, you're going to have to show me some evidence. So I believe Derrick J is exactly right when he says that it's a big old pail of horse crap when they say that Barack Obama is pardoning more people than has, you know, in one fell swoop. Maybe you can say it's more convicted people.
I think that might be the case. Okay. If he does it. And I think your best point so far is this is speculative. Maybe he won't be doing this after all. Maybe this is, you know, they say he probably
he's
will.
Got a pen.
Yeah.
Somebody can type something up for him right now.
Well, right. If he were a great president, he would have pardoned these people when he took office the first time.
What's he waiting for?
I mean,
do it now.
Why send out the press release? I guess is what my question is. Is, you know, why do we have a press release out on this? It would have. It was just as much work to type up the press
release. Well, I don't know if this is a press release. It's his aides expect. So someone told something to somebody. And
that aide could have spent the time typing up the piece of paper that Barack Obama was going to sign.
Exactly.
I'm just so sick of this. Oh, let's send out little feelers here and little feelers there. You know that Barack Obama knows that his aide said this. And if not, there have been so many leaks from so many administrations at this point, I don't see how I can expect anything other than that to be true. I'm just, you know, don't stop using the leaking system to get your news out and then arrest whistleblowers in the process. I'll tell you this. Barack Obama's the most opaque president. He has the most opaque administration in recent history, and he's locked up more whistleblowers than any other president.
That's true.
There's a little press release for you that nobody gives a flip about. The Bernie Sanders fan club over there doesn't care about.
Well, let's continue. The toll-free number, if you want to join us, is 855-450-FREE. The claim here is that, we'll correct what he sees as the excesses of the past when politicians eager to be tough on crime threw away the key, even for minor criminals.
And Obama, didn't he increase the number of federal raids on marijuana dispensaries four times his predecessor?
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's right. He hasn't backed down the war on drugs despite his talk about, I remember when he came out like a year ago.
I'm talking about marijuana dispensaries. Yeah.
Well, that's part of the war on drugs, right? They're still committing their war.
I'd like to separate that, though. I'd like to put that aside. It's done. The marijuana thing is no longer going to be considered a drug. I'm going to stop talking about it that way. Because, you know, the population of America, these polls where people say, should marijuana be legal, more than 50% agree now.
Yeah, I'm not even sure that I like the term drug for marijuana.
Yeah, we don't call the alcohol a drug. Right? Really? We say alcohol and drugs.
But alcohol...
I called it a hard drug last night on the show.
I think that's an appropriate use of the
many,
term.
Many people will call it a drug, but not the majority of people. Some people will call it a drug. But alcohol, at least you've done something to it. If you eat grain, handfuls of grain, you will not get drunk. Yeah. You have to ferment it and That's strain true. It and do a variety of things. Marijuana, you dry it. So it is a dried plant. In the same way that a flower that you get from the the florist that you keep for a special occasion, you dry it. That's all you do to it. Mm-hmm. And I don't think you can really call that a drug because all the rest of the drugs, I suppose besides psilocybic mushrooms.
Well, it's a drug by definition of the fact that it's changing your body chemistry.
Yeah, right? It changes, it alters your state.
It's altering your state of consciousness. I mean, by all definitions, cannabis
it's much more
has
of
a drug within it.
It's what we're called, it's a chemical within it. Okay, so the
Now
FDA,
you're really mincing words, Mr. Definition.
I'm sorry that the legal system is all about definitions of stuff, but the FDA would more accurately call marijuana a supplement than it would call it a drug, because it hasn't been processed and doesn't make medical claims.
We'll come back with more. 855. 450 free. More on the claim that Obama will be releasing these men. It's Free Talk Live.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Genesis is defined as an origin, creation, or the beginning. Genesis Communications Network began with the mission of providing you with the kind of compelling content you're listening to now. And at GCNlive.com, you'll find a free archive of our nation's history, narrated by GCN hosts. Explore, share, and pass down to future generations. GCN is the future of talk radio, but we should always strive to learn from our past. Together, we are GCNlive.com. GCN.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Is this really going to happen? Derrick J. is a doubter. He is saying that he doesn't believe it until he sees it. And I can't say I blame you, Derrick J. I think it's a great point. Barack Obama.
Wow, a politician has promised something?
No, he's not even saying anything. It's one of his aides that has leaked some information to the New York Times.
Boy, that's reliable.
Yeah, and now they're making the claim that he may, in the next few weeks, issue orders to free dozens of federal prisoners who've been locked up on nonviolent drug offenses.
Let's see the pen go to paper.
Yeah, I hope it does happen.
I'm for it, but I want to know, who's he pardoning? Are these friends of his? Are these old family
old
members?
Yeah. I'm going to be sending in an application.
There were 30,000 applications that people applied to be pardoned, and of them, how many are we getting?
Actually, I haven't gotten to that portion yet here. So according to the story here, the New York Times reporting that with many Republicans and Democrats now agreeing the nation went too far on this war on drugs, Mr. Obama holds the power to unlock that prison door, especially for young African-American and Hispanic men.
Hey, I'm sorry, I got to interrupt. The language here is too, the nation went too far? No, the politicians went too far. The nation had nothing to do with it. You know, they used these wishy-washy words to confuse the issue.
Yep.
Who actually took action?
The police.
Right. They're responsible for their actions.
And the politicians
who's
ordered
the
them
nation?
To.
That's just some wishy-washy word to blame the people for something they never even did.
Yeah, you're right about that. But even as he exercises authority more assertively than any of his modern predecessors, once again, essentially repeating the same he's so great claim from earlier, and presuming he will do it, again, he has not yet exercised that authority. Obama has only begun to tackle the problem he has identified. In the next weeks, the total number of commutations for Mr. Obama's presidency may surpass 80, but more than 30,000 federal inmates have come forward in response to his administration's call for clemency applications. A cumbersome review process has advanced only a small fraction of them, and just a small fraction of those have reached the president's desk for a signature. So that's the excerpt from the New York Times, and now the Free Thought Project picks it up here with Matt Agarist writing, "And any time the state admits it was wrong and innocent people are freed from their cages of oppression, it's a win for freedom."
No, that's not what's happening. Is the state admitting it was wrong about this? Are they freeing all of the prisoners? Or they don't give any reason why they're saying
well, right.
only these 80.
Nothing has officially been stated. It's all just been, you know, claims from his aides. So I guess, you know, maybe in and if he does sign these pardons, maybe there will be some sort of statement that is made where he'll say something like, "Gosh, we're so sorry. And I'm sorry I waited 8 years to actually do this. I could have done this 8 years ago."
This is just accidental. This is political, what do they call it, stancing or whatever.
But if it happens, shouldn't he be given some credit? I mean, if it goes through.
Okay, so many of the people who voted for Barack Obama the second time wanted him to have more free reign and not have to get elected. And that, you know, again, because, you know, this is essentially his lame duck term. And so this is what they were hoping for, things like this to occur.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I'm going to say if this happens, yep, good for him. He did the right thing. It's hopefully this is a harbinger of more things to come. If what this press release is a way to sort of feel things out and see whether he's going to have a huge political backlash, then, well, that makes him a wussy, in my opinion.
Yep.
He should go ahead and do it.
Of course he's a wussy.
If that's what he believes in. What is he worried about? Is he worried about getting arrested?
He won't be arrested.
He won't be arrested. Is he worried about his legacy? Once again, referring to him being a wussy, because if I was president, the last thing I care about is my legacy. What I care about are the lives of innocent people. So either these people deserve to be released or they don't, and this floating, this press release bullcrap is garbage.
How can you say good for him? I used to think that. When I read this headline, I was like, all right, I'll be the voice of reason here. Everyone's going to hate me for saying this, but hey, credit where credit's due. He's doing a good thing, and maybe if I applaud someone who's doing the right thing, we'll get more of that. Like
Indeed.
When the police, you know, when they're doing the wrong thing, I'll call them out on it, but when they're doing the right thing, we'll say that too. Like, hey, good job fixing the flat or whatever. But this is different. For a man to have an antidote for a disease, just to use an analogy here, he's got an antidote to a disease that 30,000 or millions of people have. And for him to selectively choose 80 people to use it on at no cost to himself.
Somebody else chose the recipients.
Likely.
So how can you pat him on the back for that?
Okay. Well, the reason would be is that, you know, he's taken the micro step here, the small step in finding hopefully the 80 most qualified people for this, the ones that the least besmirchable cases, and I'd like to see those 80 done. I'd also, after that, like to see 800 done. But remember, his signing hand's gonna get tired. If somebody told you that,
what does that mean?
Well, if somebody told you that you could release people by signing your name on a piece of paper, and I don't know how many times you got to sign it for a pardon.
Couldn't they just print up all the names on one sheet of paper and then he can just sign it one time?
I don't know.
Of course they can.
Yeah, they can do whatever they want.
I have no idea.
What do you think? It's a magic piece of paper?
Yes, it's a magic piece of paper. It's a legal sheet of paper, and then the people that, you know, the people who work in the governmental system.
No, the electronic pens will sign for them.
Just a whole bunch of them. I don't know what it takes.
Yes.
I mean, maybe it takes a real hand on a real piece of paper with one name in order to get somebody released.
It's baloney.
I don't know.
Well, the article goes on to indict the war on drugs, and they do a fine job of doing that. So I'll stop it here. But, you know, I am sort of on board with where Mark's coming from on this. It's, yes, he's a coward. Yes, politicians are cowards. That's, you know, that shouldn't be a surprise to anybody that has paid attention to how politicians behave. They run out in front of parades. They never start the parade themselves. And this is essentially Barack Obama running out in front of this parade, if he does it. And again, it hasn't happened yet. And saying, I've been here the whole time. I've always supported this. And now I've got the political gumption because I'm not risking anything at all by making this political move.
Yep.
So in my opinion, who feeds these politicians their marching orders? The military-industrial complex. And that includes the prison-industrial complex. Mm-hmm. So for Barack Obama to do this and to free 80 people from their system, to me, is him playing both sides of the cards. He's wants to get accolades from his supporters who are going to be, you know, just cheer him as the best president ever for doing this. And then he's also getting the fat check from his supporters at the prison industrial complex, not making them too mad.
That's
saying,
a good point.
Hey, thanks for keeping our system legitimate and keeping them going, not letting too many of our people out.
Well, and the Free Thought Project does point that out by saying that for every nonviolent drug offender the president frees, five more are thrown in. So, you know, on one hand, he's got this press release or this opportunity to have a photo op or whatever, go stand out with these guys that he's releasing, make it look like he's this compassionate character, when at the same time, the war on drugs continues unhindered. There are more peaceful drug users who are being arrested, likely
sure.
as he will be signing whatever pieces of paper. So he benefits politically from making it look like he's some kind of good guy when he's not stopping the war on drugs. He's just simply letting a few people out of their cages. Again, I support that. Please let some more people out of their cages. Let's, as they point out here, don't stop at 80. Let's go to 8,000 or 80,000. Okay, let's let all these peaceful people out. So, but again, that would hurt the prison industrial complex, and he certainly doesn't want to do that.
Yep, there's a lot of prison guards who need jobs.
Well, they will find jobs if we were to actually get rid of a bunch of people from the prisons because
the
there's plenty of jobs out
the
there.
The candlestick makers and the blacksmiths sure found jobs.
They'll probably find jobs they'd like more because prison jobs suck.
The candlestick makers and the blacksmiths worked in the free market and didn't have a union that could lobby to the government. That's the difference. The public sector unions that even Roosevelt spoke against are really what's killing, in many cases, this nation.
Coming up, since we're on the topic of drug use, there was the story, we talked with Adamo Freeman from copblock.org last week about the Indiana First Church of Cannabis. It was Adamo and some of the other cop blockers from Ohio. They went up there to witness this first, this sort of historic, what do you call it? I guess where they were gathering
ceremony?
For the first time, a ceremony, service, if you will, where the First Church of Cannabis gathered together for their first service. And High Times is saying that the First Church of Cannabis didn't really test any boundaries.
No.
This really wasn't some sort of important date when it really could have been. Mm-hmm. So we'll find out what their critique is here in moments. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. You can share your thoughts on the war on drugs, commuting prison sentences, or whatever's on your mind. Free Talk Live.
What if I told you that you could have the power to heal yourself and your loved ones with the gift of music? Unlock the healing secrets of the Bible with Whole Tones, a unique CD therapy program featuring seven secret ancient healing frequencies uncovered in the music of King David. Now you can get free samples of this music to discover their power to create energy, relieve stress, break negative cycles, and restore damaged DNA. For thousands of years, music has been used to heal. Ancient Greek doctors used flutes, lyres, and zithers to aid in digestion, treat depression, and induce sleep. Native Americans have used music to treat disease. Today, music is used to soothe post-operative pain, lower blood pressure, and boost immunity. Now you can benefit from healing music therapy in the comfort of your own home or office. Visit WholeTones44.com and get a free sample of the seven secret healing frequencies discovered by King David. Visit WholeTones44.com today for your free sample. That's WholeTones44.com. WholeTones44.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallo Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us toll-free. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. And we also have Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. If you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, you can go and shop with us. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. We've got links to Purse there, as well as Amazon and Walmart and some other options for you to get your online shopping taken care of. Once again, that's shop.freetalklive.com. The story over at High Times says Indiana's first church of cannabis didn't really test any boundaries, as much as we would have liked to have seen that happen. It wasn't as momentous an occasion as it could have been. This, of course, for those of you who don't know, the first church of cannabis was formed after the Indiana, was it the legislature? They passed some sort of Religious Freedom Act post the situation with people like refusing service to gay people, right, if I'm recalling correctly. And so some folks looked at the way this Religious Freedom Act was written and said that, well, this is actually a good thing for people who want to use cannabis as part of their religion, as their sacrament, for instance.
How is that? I don't see the link. How do they justify that?
Well,
I mean, I'd like it to be the case, but I don't understand how they make the connection.
You know what? I don't have the actual text of the law in front of me, so I'm not sure what the interpretation is of that. But basically, you know, the idea being that you should be free to do certain things from a religious perspective, including discriminate. They're saying, well, that would also mean that you should be free to, you know, free to use whatever
free to,
sacrament you want.
Free to have use your religion to discriminate against people. You should be free to use your religion to smoke marijuana. Is the idea?
Okay. I think we don't have the founder of the church on the line to answer that question, but that would be a good question if we did. And I did ask Adamo to send me the contact info for that guy, so maybe we'll get a chance to round him up at some point. Mike Adams writing for High Times. For those that don't know, High Times is sort of the counterculture magazine out there. It's been around for decades, and they've been reporting on cannabis, all things cannabis, for a very long time. Despite the threats made last week by Indianapolis Police Chief Rick Height and Marion County Prosecutor Terry Curry to raid the inaugural praise and worship service at the First Church of Cannabis, no arrests were made at Wednesday's event, and the overall vibe of the scene was, as one officer told High Times, quote, very quiet, unquote. In the morning hours leading up to the celebration, an army of more than 50 police officers could be seen stationed on every street corner for several city blocks surrounding the church, a presence in which the modest crowd took as a sign that trouble was brewing, and for good reason.
You don't think this is a show of force, right?
During a recent, well, this is what Adamo had told us about when he was on the line with us, was it looked like they had every cop in Indianapolis down there for this first church.
Good day to commit
an
actual crime.
Yeah, and the claim from the police, apparently, according to Adamo, was the police were saying they were there in force because they were worried about the kind of people that would be attracted to the First Church of Cannabis, that, you know, these marauding pot smokers were going to go and destroy the neighborhood or something like that.
How can these cops even say this crap with a straight face? I mean, seriously.
Given that they've interacted with marijuana users before?
These law enforcement officers have interacted with marijuana users and alcohol users in the past. And any one of them that says that their interactions with marijuana users has been worse than their interactions with alcohol users
is
a liar.
Yeah.
A big, fat government liar getting a paycheck from everybody, spewing lies out of their dirty little mouths.
During a recent press conference, city officials said they would arrest all those in attendance of the church service for crimes ranging from maintaining a common nuisance to possession of marijuana. In fact, the threat of illegal repercussions forced cannabis church founder Bill Levin in the 11th hour to nix the concept of the congregation smoking out as part of their sacramental debut.
No!
Instead, the church said they would challenge the city's threats in civil court.
Oh, that's going to be more successful.
It's a total
challenge
cop
them in
out.
Criminal court. If you've got 50 of them, how many people were there at the event?
Does I heard there were a couple hundred people there.
Okay, you got a couple hundred people and 50 cops. How many people is it going to take?
They can't arrest everybody.
They can't do it. And you think they're going to prosecute all 500 people or whatever they arrest?
Not if they refuse to take the plea deal
fill
and
up
they
those
demand
jail cells.
They should have people. They should have passed out roll your own cigarettes, and then had people bring their own marijuana cigarettes, mm-hmm. and then that way they're dispersed amongst the crowd, and the police can try to figure out who's got what.
We called that the jokers and the tokers when we did it here in Keene, New Hampshire, and we did it without having a church. We did just go down to Keene Central Square and smoked cannabis on multiple occasions back in 2009 and made international, you know, headlines. We made Cannabis Culture Magazine, which is High Times' main competitor. And we did that in one instance. We did this jokers and tokers, where the jokers were the people smoking a hand-rolled tobacco cigarette or a mint or a clove or something like that. And then the tokers were the people that were actually smoking cannabis, and they were kind of mixed in amongst one another for the exact purpose that you're describing there.
This just breaks my heart because
it's
what a missed opportunity. You know, I just referenced earlier the statistic about more than 50% of Americans now support the legalization of cannabis in the U.S., and just this would have been the opportunity after that statistic, now that people support it, to say, I'm willing to take the consequences of this bad drug law. I'm going to be a good person and disobey bad laws. And to have all the support of hundreds of people behind you.
This was huge.
You don't even need hundreds of people to smoke up. You need maybe 5-10 people, and then you've got hundreds around supporting you. So it's intimidating for the police. They don't want to make those kinds of arrests. There might have been a victory here for activists. Even if they got arrested, it could have been a victory. It could have been a bigger media story.
Absolutely it would have been. And this is,
I don't blame anybody who doesn't want to get arrested for this.
But think
then
about
Then don't start the first church of cannabis. I mean, what's the point? Why, what was this? Just an exercise and an idea because you didn't follow through.
He's going through the court system.
Oh, and what's going to happen when you ask permission from government bureaucrats, Mark?
They're going to say no.
Right. The whole point of this is, look, is this your belief? Is this your religion, or is this just a joke? I mean, if it's really your religion, if you really, you know, believe that cannabis is an important part of your religious process, and there are people who believe this, right? The Rastafarians for a long time, the Church of the Invisible Hand as well. There are a number of churches out there who they use cannabis or other drugs to acclimate, or I guess to get in touch with the spiritual world, for lack of a better term, to reach out to God, to commune with God. If this was really their belief, then they should have exercised their beliefs even under the threat of the aggression. That's what a lot of religious leaders would have done over time. Muhammad, Jesus. I mean, these are people who put their freedom on the line.
People far less courageous have done better things. I mean, think about during Prohibition, the people who liked beer, openly drank beer and had that out in the streets. And they went on marches saying, we want beer. And that wasn't something they were ashamed to do. And look at the pictures of these cops in these High Times photographs.
Cops, yeah.
It looks just like Prohibition days. The cops are lined up outside where they know the lawbreakers are going to be. It used to be alcohol. Today it's pot. I'm sick of it.
What is, and look, I'm not in Indianapolis or Indiana. If you're in Indiana and you know, I'm sure we can actually probably look it up pretty quick on Normal. I just don't have it pulled up. The National Organization for Marijuana Law Reform, or the reform of marijuana laws. Anyway, Normal has a good state-by-state breakdown of what are the laws. What would they have been facing had they actually been arrested legally, you know, for this? What would the legal consequences be? I know that here in New Hampshire, they can drop it to a Class B misdemeanor if you get arrested for cannabis, which means you don't get a jury trial. And obviously, it would be, I think, a really important thing to be able to get a jury trial on these charges. But even if you couldn't get a jury trial, as you pointed out, Derrick J., if you load up that system with 50 arrests, if they actually manage to arrest 50 people for smoking pot, that's a lot of clogging of that court system that those folks could do. Each one of those 50 could decide to take it to trial. They could go to trial. They could clog it up and then ultimately refuse to pay a fine. And, you know, let them deal with that.
And good luck finding a member of the jury who hasn't heard about the story already, by the way.
Well, that's what I'm saying. They could avoid maybe a jury trial. Depends on what the laws are there in Indianapolis. So if they could get a jury, then that would be even more of a reason to go through with this. But even if they couldn't get a jury, just loading up the system with 50 frivolous marijuana possession cases that have a religious freedom basis, that's a good position to be coming from to argue. You're arguing your freedom of religion, and how many times has that really been done? How many times has it been done in Indiana?
I don't know, but it's my understanding that some Native American tribes can use certain substances, so I don't know.
I don't know. I've heard the Rastafarians have lost on this, but I honestly don't know the history of the legal history in the courts of America as to how the claim that the use of marijuana is intrinsic with one's religion, how successful that is or is not.
Is it possible we're not being fair to these people? Because I heard anecdotally one caller to Cop Block Radio said that he smelled the lingering smell of marijuana inside this church building and that there were police there. Could have arrested them.
Ademo did say that he thought maybe one or two people did actually smoke.
So maybe the cops backed down. Maybe this is a success story.
But if so, why not tout that? Why wouldn't the owner of the church, the main minister here, Bill, why wouldn't he be saying, we did this anyway?
Right.
You know, we stood on our principles. We'll come back with more in moments. Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, July 6th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.59 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,165 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $274. Antiwar.com reports Yemeni state media reported a flurry of Saudi airstrikes yesterday in the Hajjah province, slamming the Ahim marketplace and killing at least 30 civilians and wounding an unspecified number of others. Locals confirmed the attacks but could not confirm the final death toll, saying Houthi forces had quickly moved in and blocked off the marketplace, ferrying ambulances back and forth to take the wounded to nearby hospitals. Yemen's Houthis and its military allies reportedly retaliated against the military airport in the southern city of Najran, reportedly destroying a tank and armored vehicle. One Saudi soldier was slain and dozens of others were wounded. Neither Saudi officials nor their allies in the former Hadi government addressed the attacks in Hajjah. Those strikes killing massive number of civilians have been common throughout the Saudi war against Yemen.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports after weeks of posturing and refusal by Greece to accept fiscal terms necessary to bail it out of deep fiscal trouble, Greek voters on Sunday effectively told creditors the same thing. Thanks, but no thanks. As Greece continues to struggle to try to stay afloat amid its serious debt crisis, billions of dollars in financial relief offered by international creditors were rejected by a highly anticipated voter referendum on Sunday. Sunday's referendum on the bailout terms skewed heavily in the no column, exactly as Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras hoped, with the vast majority of the votes siding with the leader's Syriza party. Needing to pay a $1.7 billion payment to the International Monetary Fund by the end of June, but not having the cash to do so, Athens engaged in numerous negotiations over the last 4 months, hoping to strike a deal to unlock the remainder of $7 billion in relief cash previously granted by the organization. However, demands by creditors for Athens to cut government spending in exchange for the relief proved to be the deal breaker. Tsipras reportedly rejected the offer, saying the cuts would affect Greek workers' wages and state-funded pensions. Last week, Greece defaulted on the loans, and Tsipras, not wanting to uniformly reject help without public support, ordered Sunday's referendum. By late Sunday, 60% had voted against the IMF's bailout terms. German Chancellor Angela Merkel and French President Francois Hollande spoke by telephone Sunday night and agreed the Greek voters' decision must be respected. expected. A spokesman for the German government said the chancellor and the president are in favor of calling for a summit of Eurozone heads of state and government heads on Tuesday.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports a Maine man died during a 4th of July celebration on Saturday night when he tried to launch a firework from the top of his head and it exploded, killing him instantly, according to police. Devin Staples of Calais, Maine, was drinking and celebrating the holiday in a friend's backyard when he placed the firework mortar tube on his head around 10 p.m., according to Stephen McLaughlin, a spokesman for the State Department of Public Safety. McLaughlin said it was unclear whether the firework was already lit or whether Staples lit it once it was on his head. He was killed instantly when it exploded. The tube Staples was using was a reusable mortar shell, according to McLaughlin, but said investigators did not know what type of firework he was attempting to shoot. Maine has allowed the sale of fireworks since lawmakers repealed a 60-year-old ban on them in 2011. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
NASA announced the discovery of a mile-wide asteroid this week that could potentially trigger a global level of extinction, forcing upscale fashion retailer Nordstrom out of business. Researchers confirm that the celestial object is traveling at speeds exceeding 29,000 miles per hour, threatening to slam into the planet with more than a million megatons of force, enough to jeopardize operations at all 117 full-line Nordstrom locations.
Unless we can find some way to divert or intercept the asteroid, all 7 billion people on Earth, including all 62,500 Nordstrom employees may die. Even if the asteroid breaks into smaller pieces upon entering to the atmosphere, a death toll as low as several hundred million could still slow foot traffic in stores and reduce online orders from Nordstrom subsidiary Hot Look.
Humanity is surprised it still hasn't figured out an alternative to letting power-hungry assholes decide everything. And a magical office worker is able to turn everything he touches into more work for his colleagues.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us here as we launch into the third hour of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The Indiana First Church of Cannabis, according to the High Times article by Mike Adams, didn't really test any boundaries. And that's because basically the founder of the church, Bill Levin, backed down in the 11th hour in the face of legal repercussions. The Cannabis Church founder decided to nix the concept of the congregation smoking out as part of their sacramental debut. Instead, he said the church would challenge the city's threats in civil courts, which seems like a cowardly thing to do. You're not really standing on your principles here. This was the whole concept behind the church, was that it was supposed to be a cannabis church. Was that just a we-talk-about-cannabis kind of church? I mean, come on. So it's Ian, Derrick, Jay, and Mark in the studio. You can join us here. Our Skype username's lrn.fm. Maybe you're there in Indianapolis and you've got better insight as to what's going on. According to High Times, on Wednesday, the overall attitude of the Indianapolis police felt considerably different than the previous wild-eyed drug war rantings of their boss. The department refused to admit that their presence in front of the church had anything to do with marijuana.
Which is ridiculous.
Lieutenant Richard Riddle, a spokesperson for the PD, told reporters officers were simply there as a public safety precaution and to control traffic like they would any other event in Indianapolis.
There are a lot of church events in Indianapolis, and I'd be venture to say they don't
have
40 cops.
None of them have cops showing up. 200 to 300 people showing up for church isn't an unusual thing to happen at a very, you know, medium to large-sized church.
Yeah.
So going on here, he says, we're simply responding to public safety issues and complaints from the community. Obviously, we have traffic control at a number of events. We have traffic control at churches. We have traffic control for funerals and sometimes
when
on
Easter.
When
they have these complaints thing, I'm not sure, like, okay, can you trot out these people? Because people have a right in this country to face their accusers. I'd like to know who's complaining. And I also...
No, they won't do that.
Yeah, I'd also like to strip anybody who works for the government from their ability to complain.
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
Because when the police say, yes, I am complaining about what's going on in my neighborhood, well, you know, it's kind of a conflict of interest. You're here to keep the peace, not decide what the peace is supposed to be.
When High Times, however, called the officer out for providing the press with a statement inconsistent with the threats made by city law enforcement officials, because again, they said they would arrest anybody for smoking pot, he responded by lopping the force's highly publicized warning in with the issue of public safety. Riddle said, quote, we're planning on contingencies. If people choose to possess marijuana, we will enforce the state law that the state legislature has told us is illegal.
But if the state legislature even considers for a moment getting rid of marijuana, we will go and testify about how terrible we think an idea we think that is. Because we aren't, in fact, law enforcement officers. We are policy makers.
It's true. You're not exaggerating. Every time there's
been any hearing.
I've
been doing this crap too long, and I've seen these police officers talk out of both sides of their mouths like lying scumball politicians that they claim to be obeying.
They show up at every hearing, even medical marijuana hearings, and they testify as hard as they can about how this is going to be terrible for the young people of America or the young people of Indianapolis or New Hampshire or Indiana or wherever it is the hearings are happening. And then they trot out every officer they possibly can, and they bring out the kids, and they have the kids read some sort of prepared statement about how bad marijuana is, and just the same old song and dance every single time.
Don't forget the solution is always more police power.
That's right.
Yeah. Viva just we'll following orders. You can't say that and then come testify at the hearings to make marijuana legal.
Well, they can. Apparently, they do that a lot.
They're liars. Yeah. It's my job as the press. It's my job with 150 radio stations to point out the bald-faced lies of these police officers. In many cases, it's the brass. Sometimes you can get a police officer face-to-face and you can talk to them about drug legalization, and they'll, you know, they won't lie about it. But there's plenty of them within the ranks that talk out of both sides of their mouths, too.
If people don't possess marijuana, said the officer, and don't openly use marijuana and practice their religion, which they have a right to do, there's not going to be any issues and they won't be bothered.
You can practice your marijuana smoking religion by not smoking marijuana.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Riddle continued by saying that officers were only looking for people who are, quote, openly and publicly flaunting the possession of marijuana, and that those individuals, quote, would be subject to arrest, which was a far cry from their previous no-tolerance attitude.
So does that mean it's okay if people are, like, discreetly smoking?
I highly doubt that.
Well, what if you're just keeping it to yourself? What if you're not passing the joint around?
Perhaps this change of draconian heart was out of respect for Levin's recent decision to ban all illegal substances from the church grounds. Then again, as Ohio attorney Bryce Keller pointed out, this shift in strategy likely had more to do with the fact that the whole nation was watching for something dramatic to unfold. Cop block is here, said the founder of the church, Mr. Keller. Cop block and the news and everybody having all these video recording devices everywhere probably has caused the police captain or somebody to say, be on your toes today and make sure what we're doing is protecting the peace. He continues to say if police were going to arrest somebody for a minor offense, that there would be a swarm of people out there with their video recorders and it wouldn't be good for anybody. What do you mean it wouldn't be good for anybody? It would be great for your church's publicity if there were 50 video cameras around when somebody gets arrested for smoking cannabis, because each one of those video recordings is going to go up on YouTube. Each one of those people that are recording it are going to share their recording with all of their friends, and they're going to share it with their friends, and then it's going to go even more viral than this concept already had gone.
Yeah, I think that if some people were willing to get arrested here at this event, and you know, to some extent it's the organizer who's breaking weak on it. If they were willing to do that, that it would get more publicity. This is the time. You know, I don't care.
For this?
I don't care what the drug warriors and the social conservatives say. Marijuana's you know, becoming legal across the United States. It's the, you know, speaking as an elected Republican, I am so sorry that my party seems to be on the wrong side of so many social issues. They're just like, oh, let's fight about this gay marriage stuff. And then the Supreme Court goes in. I mean, it's not like you didn't know what the Supreme Court was going to do. Gay marriage was a loser. Gay marriage was a loser, and you haven't gotten a better seat in heaven by running your yik and yakker on the Facebooks, okay? Just stop, Republicans. Stop getting behind losing campaigns. Yes, people who are in this country who got here by breaking the law, committing a misdemeanor, are probably going to be able to stay here. Stop making such a big deal about people who want them to have a better life for themselves. Stop worrying about the drug war. Please, for God's sake, worry about an issue you might be able to have some effect on, like fiscal responsibility within the government. That's a winner for Republicans. Republicans are always talking about the national debt until they get in power and their politicians just feed them a bunch of lies again. The political process is so broken. It's broken not because of the politicians, but because of the people that support them.
So do you have any hope that this guy will be successful going through the political process?
I could care less. He's waiting. This is Indiana.
Well, what do you mean?
If he wants to be successful, he should move to Colorado. I mean, I don't care about his success.
Yeah. Why didn't he do that? Why didn't he start his Church of Cannabis in a place where it's already legal?
Well, if the point was to challenge... But apparently it wasn't. Okay. Yeah, I guess you're right about that. Before he chickened out.
If he wanted to bring recreational or religious marijuana to the state of Indiana, the boat...
He failed.
He let the boat pass.
And if he all of a sudden finds his courage, you know, next month or something like that, and changes his mind and then goes out there and says, this time we're really going to do it.
Nobody cares. I don't know
if he's going to get the same turnout. I don't think people would be as excited about it.
No, everyone thought it was going to happen this time.
Right. And, you know, I think what happened here in Keene is instructive and should be instructive for anybody who's considering doing something similar to this. Again, in Keene, we didn't have the freedom of religion thing going on at the time that the cannabis celebrations were happening here, the 420s that were going on a daily basis. But what happened was the police came in, they targeted the leader. So, you know, Bill probably knew he was going to get arrested as the primary mover on this, and he probably didn't want that to happen. But they targeted Rich Paul.
Arrest isn't so bad.
No, it's not. But people who've never been through it, it's bad to them.
I mean, if you've
got
to get to work the next day, I mean, obviously it can be a bit of a pain.
It's a scary thing. It's a scary thing. And so they arrested the people they considered to be leaders. The groups, the group of smokers went down to the police station and smoked out inside the police station. And then after that, the cops let us alone. They let it happen. The cops were
saying... They smoked in the police station, that's why.
Right. They were saying officially, oh, well, there was no one smoking in the park. We've been through there, and there was no one smoking pot in the park. That was their official story.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you can join us here on the radio waves to talk about whatever you want to discuss. Just dial on in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the disappointing First Church of Cannabis. They had their first service last week. It was attended by a couple hundred people, according to Adamo Freeman from copblock.org, who was there to observe. He was outside more interacting with the police than inside the church.
I saw a video of it. There was a lot of singing and dancing going on.
Inside the church.
Yeah, and to his credit, the man who ran this event, I forget
Bill
his name.
Keller,
Bill something, said during his speech at the end of it something similar to the Rich Paul ceremonial, we smoke these in remembrance of those who've lost their liberties in hopes for a day when cannabis will be legal or something. And he did say, smoke them if you got them. So he did.
Interesting.
He did sort of give an opportunity for people who wanted to smoke.
But also prior to that, told people not to, right?
Yeah.
Asked them to not.
A very conflicted message.
I
doubt they would be prepared to smoke up if he warned them that they wouldn't be able to.
So we're going to talk more about that here in a moment, and the High Times perspective saying they really didn't test any boundaries here. If you want to get Bitcoin, the price, by the way, has gone up over the last few weeks. What did it hit? 278 today, I think, at one point, dropping back down to like maybe 275 right before the show. It's looking good right now. Maybe it's going to keep going up. Maybe not. You don't know. But the reason to get Bitcoin, in my opinion, isn't necessarily because you expect it's going to go up. That's a decent reason to do it. But it's also because it's an exciting currency. This is the world's first truly international currency. It is not issued by any government or any bank. This is the currency of and for the people, and it really is an amazing thing. It's got the world's largest financial network. It's decentralized, meaning it can't be attacked. It can't be taken down. It's basically impossible and impervious to hacking. Otherwise, it would have happened by now. Bitcoin is awesome. It's cryptographically secure, and it's being accepted by more and more companies and individuals around the world. You can get big companies like Dell computer, Wikipedia, they're taking Bitcoin, and even small companies, mom and pop companies right here in our very own Keene, New Hampshire. There's a corner store on Main Street that that takes Bitcoin. There's a vegetarian food truck that takes Bitcoin. There's a hair salon. So it makes it easy to transact business, to send money from one point to another, even all the way around the world. And the people in Greece, of course, have started to see this. They've been jumping on board with Bitcoin in a major way, which is probably one of the reasons why it's gone up over in recent weeks, gone up in price. So maybe you're thinking about getting some. Well, here's how you can get up to $40 worth of Bitcoin for no fee whatsoever. I mean, you got to pay the $40, but no fee on top of the $40.
You have to buy the Bitcoins, right, but you have to pay the fee to buy the Bitcoins.
There is no fee on top of the actual cost of the Bitcoins. Over at expresscoin.com, when you use coupon code FTL, now maybe you want to get Litecoin or Dogecoin or something like that, you can do that too, and you can, again, get up to $40 worth of any of those cryptocurrencies for no transfer fee with code FTL. Now, when you go above $40, then there's a very small fee. I believe it is 3%, which I think you'll find is the best, if not one of the best, in the business of transferring money into Bitcoin. But go see for yourself. Expresscoin.com. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business. You do need to be in the U.S. or Canada to use their services at this time. But go to expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL.
You also don't need to use a bank. I've used ExpressCoin with just a money order.
With a money
from
order,
the post
right.
office.
Yeah, check or money order. And that works well. In fact, I don't think they're doing the wire transfers right now.
Good. So, yeah, I don't want to go to the bank for
Bitcoin. You got to use money orders. In fact, you can even go to some Walmarts will give you money orders for free. Not all of them.
Oh, yeah?
The one here in Keene, it's like 40 cents or 50 cents or something. But back in Florida, they were free. And I guess that's just because Walmart wants you to come in and shop there.
I used to get them from a place called Amscot, which is one of these check cashing places.
Would they do them free there?
Yeah, they were doing them free there. They're basically trying to get walk-in traffic to their check cashing place. I don't even know what exactly check cashing places do precisely. I guess they can.
They loan money out to people, short-term loans.
Yeah, I'm not interested in that.
Bunch of money on that.
I got some money orders.
So, High Times, continuing here with their story. If you want to share your experience, maybe you've been in Indianapolis at this First Church of Cannabis that seemed to basically back down at the last moment and didn't really have a mass smokeout as they could have. On the issue of probable cause, Bill Keller, the founder of the church, said police would need to establish it for each individual and that simply being on the premises of the cannabis church did not give authorities the right to initiate random searches. Well, that's certainly true. What the Indianapolis police chief initially said was the force was going to cite parishioners for visiting a common nuisance, which Keller said could have been used as a gateway to search the pockets of parishioners and perhaps even their vehicles. But in the end, there was no shakedown, not a single incident in which the Indianapolis Police Department felt the need to investigate or attempt to establish probable cause of any kind. Some supporters of the First Church of Cannabis chastised Levin on Monday after he announced that marijuana would not be allowed in the or at the first service.
Boo.
Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. Keller. Wait, I'm confused. I think it was Bill Levin was his name. I was calling him Bill Keller.
Yeah, it's
I apologize
Levin.
About that. So they chastised Bill Levin, the founder, on Monday after he announced that marijuana would not be allowed
Who's
at the
they?
First service.
Who chastised?
Some of their supporters.
Yeah, I would.
Yep. Social media lit up with angry potheads revoking their backing for the cause. Some even calling it a scam. Levin has said all along that marijuana use in church is protected under Indiana's new Religious Freedom Restoration Act and that cannabis consumption would take place within the congregation from day one. So many supporters felt that the poobah had lost his nerve and that his talk of civil disobedience in the name of cannabis was a complete sham. And I can't blame them for feeling that way. What a letdown. I mean, it would be a huge letdown to have actually spent the time and the effort to help promote this event, to promote the church, to go there and under the belief that this was going to happen, and then to have the main guy who put it all together back down in the last moment.
I mean, are you kidding me? And his comment about not wanting all the cameras and the media attention. Like, you've already got all this media attention focused on your event. You're not going to use your stage that you've created here.
I'm going to apologize. I was saying that was Levin, but that was actually not Levin
who said that.
I need to figure out who the heck Keller is.
Who is that?
That I have yet to actually figure out. Please continue with your commentary.
Yeah, however. Well, I'm just annoyed because, you know, I did some civil disobedience marijuana activism that didn't have a bunch of media attention. And you could bet that if I knew that there were going to be a bunch of cameras and hundreds of supporters, that would have been even more likely to do it.
You're more safe with cameras and supporters around. Keller is an attorney, not necessarily their attorney, just an attorney.
So I'm just extremely disappointed that this guy, you know, he built this stage for this activism and then didn't use it. I mean, it would be like a band billing a show and then not playing.
Basically, yeah. That's I can totally see where you're coming from there.
Or at least not playing their hits.
Yeah, that would be a disappointment, right? Playing all the B-sides and the deep tracks or whatever.
Deep tracks.
No one can sing along right. In that case. In all fairness, according to High Times, however, while there may have been a level of fear behind Levin's choice to ban weed from the church, which is based on including marijuana as part of its ritualistic repertoire, ultimately his goal was achieved, to lean on the passing of a discriminatory law in order to create a S-storm of media attention, no matter how convoluted the overall message has become. But didn't he buy this church building?
Well, there is kind of something to be said for the strategy he's using. Like, towing the line just to point out how ridiculous a law is a strategy.
We'll come back with more here in moments. And I'll do the digging and find out what the penalties are for marijuana possession in Indiana. There's more on the way. You can share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
Have you ever wondered if you could make electric, light, or heat in your home for free? How about a motor that charges batteries at the same time? What if this also restores useless batteries and saves you lots of money? Come to our Renaissance Charge Conference Workshop on August 15th and 16th in Fort Lauderdale. Visit r-charge.com. That's r-charge.com for details. Or call 208-304-2954. 208-304-2954.
Do good people ever want to call an attorney just to find out if they're right or wrong? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what are you forced to think about first? Money. If you could call as often as you wanted and talk as long as you need without a bill, would you call? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
An unpopular police officer thinks about committing a racially motivated offense for a little support. A middle-aged man is having the best snacks of his life, and a housefly drops everything to go stand on a watermelon slice. This is The Onion Week in Review. Noting the Youth Center's ping pong table and array of DVDs and Blu-rays, local youth minister Mark Kindler told reporters this week that his church's new rec room has everything a teen could want. The youth pastor revealed that the basement facility's many teen-friendly amenities include a new Wii U console, an iPod dock for the teens to play any music they like, and some comfortable recliners for those who just want to relax or do their homework after school.
We've really gone out of our way to give the rec room a laid-back atmosphere. It's stocked with snacks, but sometimes at the end of the week, we'll spring for some pizza. Honestly, I wish I had a place like this when I was their age.
In other news, increased violence leads the State Department to issue an advisory for Americans traveling to 1861, and an elderly lobbyist is always droning on about how little legislation used to cost in his day.
This is the Onion News Network.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free if you want. Our number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. Skype username is LRN.FM. The First Church of Cannabis is on the table for discussion, but of course, it's an open phone show, so you can call in about anything you would like to discuss. You can also watch the show on our webcam. Go to cam.freetalklive.com, and you can see what's going on in the studio. There's really not that much going on. It's just three guys sitting in chairs talking into microphones. But some people like to watch those things, so you can go
There's a great chat room that's attached.
That's true. The chat room is the real draw, in my opinion. But
it's lively.
Yeah. You can go to the chat room by itself if you want. That's chat.freetalklive.com. But if you go to cam.freetalklive.com, the chat room is actually built in to the same page as the cam. And it's all free. So please go and enjoy. Once again, that's cam.freetalklive.com. High Times is dissecting the First Church of Cannabis. The first service was held last week. There were a lot of people attending. And the founder of the church, Bill Levin, decided in the last moment, basically, to scuttle the whole idea of smoking cannabis, which, of course, is the whole concept of the church itself.
No, but wait a minute. A lot of people, they could have come to the church service high if they didn't want to smoke there. Maybe they smoked beforehand, or maybe they ate some edibles that lasted them the entire service. You know?
I don't doubt that someone was high during the Church of Cannabis first service. However, the whole idea was to make a statement,
right,
and I feel like the full statement wasn't made. Now, High Times is giving him credit for responding to a discriminatory law to create media attention, and he certainly did achieve that. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of media attention. There was an article in Time magazine about their first service, and there were a number of stories written about this.
Yeah.
But it didn't go as far as it could should have.
I don't know. I'm changing my mind on this a little bit. Like, Dale, who's been on the show criticizing some of the activism that happens in Keene, has brought up that sometimes activism can be better without the arrest. If you do civil disobedience and you toe the line right up to it, but you're not breaking the law, you can still force the government's hand and make them show of force. There are
sure,
all these police officers.
It looked bad for that. Sure.
Yeah, they were there to bust some people who have a plant, okay? And that doesn't look good in the mainstream media when this story blows up.
Well, they do get they use their standard out, which is we had a complaint.
Well,
and they remember they use this a lot.
Yeah.
And this is a standard issue lie. If for instance they find somebody walking down the street, they'll say we've had some complaints of some burglaries in the area. Of course you have. The city's been incorporated for 200 years. Mm-hmm. There have been complaints of burglaries in
point.
The area, and we're not exactly sure of the area, right? So this is just a big fat lie.
The area of Indianapolis.
Right.
There's been a burglary.
Right.
Somewhere.
And somebody's complained
you
about
look like our suspect.
Marijuana smoking sometime in the history of Indianapolis.
My point is, the way this was done, he gets all the benefit of the news stories without all of the risks of arrest, without all of the problems and legal defense funds that need to be set up afterwards. Most people who hear about this story, they hear a blip about it, they hear the headline, oh, Church of Cannabis is doing their thing, and okay, great. Most people who don't even read the story are going to assume that people did smoke anyway.
I am looking here at the penalties in Indiana, for possession for personal use. It is a Class B misdemeanor, punishable by not more than 180 days imprisonment. So that's, you know, again, there's different classes in different states. So Class B misdemeanor in New Hampshire means that there is no jail time possible for it.
Right.
Here, half a year is the possibility. So that may mean that a jury trial would have been possible. And again, I'm not an Indiana legal expert here, but generally, jury trials are reserved for people who face jail time. At least that's how it is here in New Hampshire. If you're in Indiana and you can clarify that, please feel free to do so. Back to High Times and their viewpoint here. All of the national coverage brought out a gang of half-cocked protesters on Wednesday, fully prepared to express their disdain for the official launch of the First Church of Cannabis. Signs with anti-pot messages reading, "Religious freedom does not mean freedom to commit crimes," were displayed across the street by several members of the community who said they were at the event to support the police. This protest, however, caused some controversy among parishioners, not only because of the ignorance of the opposition, but over concerns that these people had the gall to put signs of protest in the hands of young children. Well, I mean, that's just what people do. If they've got kids and they're going to a protest, they're going to bring their kids along to participate. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, I can't besmirch one side for doing it, even if I disagree with them, because I don't go after the other side. When I see kids at protests, protests that I agree with, and I'm like, okay, you know, or I don't even know if protest the right word, events.
Always looks wrong to me. I don't care. Even if it's on like pro-liberty side, it seems indoctrinative.
That's exactly what it is. You're indoctrinating your children into your belief system.
You're going to anyway. I mean, that's life, man.
Yeah, but why can't they have a play date that day? Like, why do they have to go do activism at age 5?
Well, you're supposed to leave them with somebody?
Wrong? I mean, there are other people in the world who can be responsible for your child for a couple hours. Yeah, I don't think that's crazy.
Now you need babysitters, and you know it's getting expensive.
Or family members.
No, it's not everybody's got family
members. Why should your kids be shielded from activism? I mean, if that's what you're doing as a parent, if that's what is, you know, part of your family's behavior is to be activists.
Because I think they should choose.
Bring them in.
I think they should choose what activism they want to do.
At what age?
Whenever they voluntarily say, I'm going to go do this.
Hey,
I'm go
son,
do
you want to go hold a sign with us at the First Church of Cannabis today?
My son expressed interest in selling lemonade at Uncle Ian's house. Frankly, well, I'm not going to come here and watch him all day while he tries to sell lemonade for a dime.
You heartbreaker.
Now you want the kid to protest. Yeah. You want him to break the law.
He chose. No, because he chose to do it.
He doesn't know what the law is.
So
I didn't
what?
Say.
Good. He shouldn't know what the law is. That shouldn't matter.
So if
he wants to do a lemonade stand, the answer is yes. Well, I will help you.
I would agree with you, Derrick J. If someone's child does not want to be at a protest and they've been forced to be there, I would disagree with forcing one's children to go and participate. But
it just looks bad. You know, looks bad to me whenever there's kids on one side or another.
I think it's adorable, like when kids are selling lemonade illegally and like standing up to the police or whatever. I think that's pretty cool. Didn't they do that with the Lemonade Freedom Day?
Yeah, Lemonade Freedom Day makes that happen. I like that too.
Yeah, you were talking about that on your radio show, Peace News Now, weren't you?
Yeah, and I went. I attended the Lemonade Freedom
Day.
Did
you chastise those parents for bringing their kids out to that?
No. In fact, I purchased lemonade and raw milk from them.
There you go. Now you're just encouraging them to come out and do more activism. You hypocrite.
Well, all right. You're right.
All right. Let's move on here from High Times. Continuing the church. Let's see. While the concern for the First Church of Cannabis was with the actions of law enforcement, it ended up being the angry protesters that created all the unnecessary tension throughout the day's event. There was reportedly a threat of arson during the service, and a couple of preachers opposing the legitimacy of the church got into a street fight with one another, in which police were forced to intervene. As for the church service itself, it was a bit of a sideshow, complete with a few balloons and band playing reggae renditions of songs like Tom Petty's Mary Jane's Last Dance. Mm-hmm. Admittedly, the initial part of the service seemed like...
It does mention Indiana in that song.
Admittedly, the initial part of the service seemed like a giant warm-up act to prepare the crowd for Levin's arrival. It was perhaps this rock show approach that contributed to city leaders comparing Levin's mission to Indiana cult leader Jim Jones over the past few weeks. He have people kill themselves by drinking poisoned Kool-Aid?
That's correct.
A Kool-Aid stand outside of the church poked fun at those comments. Unfortunately, the church's inaugural service came off no differently than the thousands of other locally driven legalization rallies that happen every year across the United States. Without the use of cannabis, not much was achieved that hadn't already been with the coverage leading up to the event. It was almost a shame to see something with that had generated so much power to be unleashed only to come Pacquiao Mayweather fight of the cannabis movement. Some boxing reference, perhaps?
Yes.
Yeah, that was a recent boxing
and a big
fight.
Deal.
Was it like a disappointment?
Yeah,
ultimately,
it was a huge
or something?
Disappointment. Yeah, the I honestly forget which one.
Yeah,
the guy who was all talk like lost or whatever. I don't know. I think that's what happened.
Yet,
no. He wanted everything his way, and then he won. Big disappointment.
Yet says High Times. We look forward to seeing what happens next, and we'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts here. And an update on the Baltimore case. Remember the guy that the Baltimore cops allegedly killed that caused all those protests? There's an interesting development there. More coming up here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of Ionic Silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us and share whatever's on your mind. We've been talking about the First Church of Cannabis, which really kind of backed down on the promise of being a First Church of Cannabis. They're a cannabis-supporting church, but not actually a cannabis-using church, at least not during their ceremony, which, of course, seemed to be the whole purpose of forming the church. So, I don't know. We'll see what happens over time here. As High Times has pointed out, they really didn't push the test any boundaries with their first service that happened last week, which initially had been promoted as a place to come to and to use cannabis in a religious manner.
Do you
and
think it was that
it didn't happen?
Do you think it was that there were a bunch of police there? I mean, what if they set this precedent that, like, oh, it's this big disappointment, nobody smokes pot here, and then the police leave them alone next week, and it's like, all right, everybody, light up. This is for real now.
I don't know. I guess we'll see. I mean, will it be newsworthy when that happens the second time or for the first time at the second?
I don't
session.
Know. I don't know if this guy actually wants news. He just wants his church, right? So if he
but
gets
no, he
his
wanted
success,
news. He
well,
wanted to challenge the this yeah. Religious Freedom Act that was passed to justify yeah. people discriminating against gay folk.
I'm with you.
Which I think people should be able to discriminate. That should be their choice, and you know that's another issue entirely. But also, I think that you should be free to use whatever sacrament you want as part of your religion. I think they should be able to use LSD as part of their church if they want to.
Great.
So a little bit more here from the story. And, of course, you can join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. High Time says we look forward to seeing what happens next. Interestingly, it appears that the police department in Indianapolis plans on keeping close tabs on the First Church of Cannabis. From this point forward, a new surveillance camera mysteriously appeared on utility pole outside of the church the day before the first service. Talk about creepy. Although Indianapolis police denied having any knowledge of this Big Brother tactic, the consensus is it was put there to keep a watchful eye on future services. Levin wrote in a Facebook post, quote, "Thanks for the new camera outside our church. I will wave hi to you all in the mornings. Smile and wave back, will ya?" That's a story from High Times' Mike Adams. And what will happen next? I am interested in knowing, you know, hopefully we can get this guy, Bill Levin, on to talk about this because it's a big disappointment. And maybe somebody else will pick up this ball and run with it. Maybe somebody else will create the First Church of Cannabis and do this thing.
You know, what's weird to me is that, you know, I know that some of the people who are among the supporters at this Church of Cannabis, and I would think, like, why wouldn't they have lit up? Why wouldn't they have had the courage to
start
things?
He asked them not to.
Right. That's the issue, is that it's a private property issue at this point. He said no. So even if there were courageous people in the audience,
I would respect his wishes if I were there.
Well, like, hold on. Then he said smoke them if you got them at the end, though.
Yes. So it's very conflicting.
Yeah. Maybe he meant smoke them if you got them later. Not
no,
here.
It seems
on
like,
this property.
I don't know.
So I guess time will tell. Like I said, I hope somebody does this and does it right. And maybe he will start in on the second time and go for it. Maybe he just needed
nothing.
To build up his confidence and get you know 50 cops out of there. And and you're right, that may be make the difference. I mean, you've got legal representation. You've got attorneys who are going to help you out with this. It's not like he was playing this alone. He had assistance.
I know. Just putting myself in his shoes, I'm a lot more likely to openly violate a law when there's not 50 cops standing outside my door. You know what I mean? So, yeah, it wasn't courageous. But at least he made something cool happen, and it was newsworthy. I hope to see someone take up the mantle. And maybe he'll move to Colorado. Maybe. I don't know.
But then he wouldn't be achieving what he was trying to achieve.
Yeah, but he could establish the church there, and then other people could set up, you know, branch churches from there. If they've got the right in Colorado and they get left alone, they can build up their support in a place where they won't get arrested,
And look, I don't blame somebody for going to Colorado. If you like to smoke pot, you know that seems like a fine place to go to. Of course, now there's also Washington State. Alaska, and Oregon are on board with legalization now.
California basically has legalized marijuana, too. All you have to do is say, you know, sometimes I get headaches, or, you know, this my pinky toe hurts, and basically you're in.
So I don't blame anybody.
West coast of the United States, if it touches the Pacific Ocean, you can smoke pot on it, practically.
But that's so annoying. I don't want pot, or I don't want like a cannabis license. Like, I don't want to have to ask permission and be like, oh, I'm a victim. I'm hurting. I need this.
You wish you had cannabis license if you're sitting in jail for it.
Well, okay. I want the freedom to enjoy or to imbibe anything I want. You know, so it's my choice.
I want that too, but there's a path to get there, and I don't know.
No, this is not it, because when's alcohol going to be that way?
I don't know, man. Seems like it was a ways
off.
Okay,
that's been about 100 years. So are we going to have to wait 100 years for pot to be legal in the same way that alcohol is now? I mean, that's rough. That's weak.
If 20,000 liberty-minded folks would move to New Hampshire within the next 10 years, then we might actually see a repeal of prohibition on cannabis and alcohol.
How's that?
Well, because the idea of the Free State Project, for listeners that aren't familiar, is to concentrate liberty activists in one place so we're not spread out all over the damn place. That's the reason why the three of us are here tonight. That's the reason why we know you, Derrick, is because of the Free State Project, to concentrate our activism. If you got 20,000, if you've got 10,000 people who care about freedom focusing their efforts in a small state like New Hampshire, you can have an incredible effect. We've already seen how 1,500 early movers have had an amazing effect here and have moved the ball in the right direction on a number of issues.
Isn't New Hampshire the only state where cannabis has been proposed through the legislature? In all the other places, it's been through like referendums or through the courts.
I understand it, is true. Maine has decriminalization, but what you're saying is legalization was voted through the legislature in New Hampshire. I think it was the state reps. I don't think it went through the state senate. But the state, please correct me if I'm wrong on this too.
That is by no means
a compendium. I thought it went through the state senate and didn't get
legalization through. Went through the state senate.
Not legalization.
That's
what
we're talking about.
Decriminalization.
Right. Decrim
it happens
went through
all every single year, and the ball always gets moved a little bit further. That's why I have hope.
Why
with
do they
this.
Bother opposing it when they see the writing on the wall? I mean,
because
they're
protecting their jobs. The governor's in the pocket of the police unions. The police unions know their budgets are going to be cut if they don't have marijuana busts.
Can't they do something else to tyrannize
the
people?
They can't.
This
nothing is that easy.
People being here makes a big difference. We've seen it already. We've got more than a dozen Free State Project participants already elected to state rep positions. One of them, Amanda Bolden, just put forth legislation that was overwhelmingly adopted by both the State House and the Senate, and signed by the governor, that legalizes possession of one drug, which is called Narcan. Now, that's a name brand for essentially it's a product, a drug that counteracts the overdose of heroin or any opiate overdose. It used to be illegal to possess Narcan as just an average person. Let's say you have a loved one who you know is a heroin problem and you want to have something around the house to make sure that if they have an overdose that you have a way to help get them out of that, at least temporarily. It's not a cure-all. It only lasts on a temporary basis to give them enough time to get to the hospital and get real treatment for it. But now that's legal. So that's a lifting of a prohibition that has happened here in New Hampshire. Another prohibition that was lifted because of a free stater that was elected to state rep, Jen Coffey. This was years ago. She put forward a piece of legislation that legalized possession of all knives. You know, the classic stuff that's illegal in places where we're from, like Jersey and Florida, butterfly knives and switchblades and things like
gravity
that.
Knives, yeah.
All of it's legal in New Hampshire, is my understanding, is basically thanks to Free
Sharp
State Project.
Pieces of metal are legal in New Hampshire.
Yeah. So, I mean, those, I think, are real indicators that this can be a success, but we've got to change. We've got to get people to come here. I mean, if libertarians actually did stand behind their ideas with action in one place, like here in New Hampshire, I think we'd see amazing things. And I think we will see them. It's just it's going to take a while for them to get here.
We see a preview of that every year at Porkfest, where we just came from the Porcupine Freedom Festival, where we get a taste of what it might be like if
That's people a little, concentrate their efforts in one place.
That's a little different because at Porkfest, you've just got a bunch of liberty-oriented people being together, whereas if you get 10,000 liberty-oriented folks to move to a state, what they're going to do is concentrate their activism in different areas, many of them within the political structure, and what that's going to do is strip away some of the most egregious laws. And so I don't know, you're going to have a Porkfest atmosphere running around.
Porkfest is a party. There's no doubt about that.
But maybe that's what the Shire will look like in 100 years.
Who knows? I hopefully we'll be around to see what that's like.
Yes, we'll all be bionic.
Vegas,
then.
Here we come.
Speaking of bionic and transhumanism and things like that, I did see the Terminator movie today.
Oh, cool.
The new one.
Oh, that's right. You're going to see that.
I did see it, and it was very good. I enjoyed it.
You ready to be a cyborg?
You know, I am not necessarily against the idea of transhumanism.
They've got bionic eyes now.
It's kind of it's a little scary on one side, but it's also very exciting on the other hand.
Yeah.
So, I'm not necessarily
Once you're facing
it.
Death, at that point is when you're going to be making your decisions in many cases. The first people that will be doing the transhumanism thing will be making their decisions at the point of death. So, you know, what's worse than dying? Trying on a robot body for size?
The critics didn't like it. Rotten Tomatoes gave it a 27%.
What'd you think?
I loved it. I thought it was fantastic.
I liked Jupiter Ascending, and nobody liked that crap either.
I was entertained
I went and saw
by that
it twice.
Movie. It was no Matrix, but it was good.
I thought it was great.
We'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime, freetalklive.com, and check out Derrick's website, thederrickj.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, July 6th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.59 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,165 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $274. Antiwar.com reports Yemeni state media reported a flurry of Saudi airstrikes yesterday in the Hajjah province, slamming the Ahim marketplace and killing at least 30 civilians and wounding an unspecified number of others. Locals confirmed the attacks but could not confirm the final death toll, saying Houthi forces had quickly moved in and blocked off the marketplace, ferrying ambulances back and forth to take the wounded to nearby hospitals. Yemen's Houthis and its military allies reportedly retaliated against the military airport airport in the southern city of Najran, reportedly destroying a tank and armored vehicle. One Saudi soldier was slain and dozens of others were wounded. Neither Saudi officials nor their allies in the former Hadi government addressed the attacks in Hajja. Those strikes killing massive number of civilians have been common throughout the Saudi war against Yemen. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports after weeks of posturing and refusal by Greece to